Dope. Yeah. Chef Zo. MP80. Truth himself.
Yeah. Oh. Chillin' with my misfits. Feeling so different. Chillin' with my misfits. Feeling so different. If you with it, come get it. Misfits, you know just how we do. 316 and we in this mix. Those not up, you know we pop it too. By my nose, so it's out of yo. Ain't no need for that chop of screw. Chillin' with misfits. Yeah, dope lyrics, you know how we do.
Chillin' with the host, Miss Misfits. DJ Lab playing the shit that's hot. Slick, I was ready to pop off. T-Mac giving it, what she got? Those not up, the one with logic. Misfits Radio High.
Tryna tune me out, LL Cool J, I'm in the house. It's all good when I'm chillin' with Misfit on the couch. DJ in the lab, mixin' a lot. You roll two chicks today. Don't snatter, you ain't tryna spin my hits. So I bought a double rotation. Got a song in a blood and rotation. Because I'm fuckin' with the hottest station to ever do it on the internet. 8316, they ain't ready yet. Yeah, I spit 316 as it to the murder. Already know it's me, don't need to ask the juror. Crossin' over like T-Mac. Got a lot like T-Mac. Dope livers, yeah, they need that. Misfit Radio, where we be.
Hottest radio station alive. Westside Misfit. Misfit Radio. Shout out to DJ Lab. We put this one together.
Yeah.
Hey. You are officially in the mix, baby. I am Miss Mix-a-Lot.
I am Dosnada 2000.
I am DJ Lab.
And you know we got Slick 316 in the building, baby.
As always, talking without a mic, you're here.
Talking without a mic. That is her for a table. Hey, man, today is a very, very, very special day.
And what makes it so special?
Today is August the 2nd, and it is a Sunday, and it's 5 years ago that Westside Misfits actually aired our first show.
Wow.
It's been 5 years to the day. Years.
Anniversary.
That's crazy. And the Sunday. Yeah. Like, our first show, of course, was we've always been here, been doing a show on Sundays at 3 o'clock. Uh-huh. And 5 years ago, August 2nd, 2015, was when our first show aired.
Wow.
So yeah, the time flies. Of course, the things that are manifested from Westside Misfits, you know, we ended up doing our own internet radio station.
That's right.
So that was, you know, that was one of the biggest accomplishments that we've gained just from starting an actual, just a podcast or radio show.
A whole media network.
So, yeah. So we got a whole media group at this point.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Where we, you know, just we doing it. And I was just like, when I went to the Facebook memories, I said, damn it. And I'm looking back through the, you know, through that Sunday.
Uh-huh.
And it was just a lot, but it was a very humbling experience. I'm glad that we got started.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad that we're continuing to go on. And what I want to do is during the show, of course, Slick had some books made for us just from some of the guests that we've had a chance to interview. So I'm going to kind of breeze through the books, put it in my stories on Instagram and Facebook, just to kind of let people know some of the people that we've actually come in contact with, as well as interviewed and just kind of built relationships with over the last 5 years.
Right.
And so it's four. We have four books.
Yeah, that's a lot of books.
Yeah, that's a lot of books. And I mean, these are a lot of memories, right? These are four books that she was able to just get in there and get pictures, just kind of use the pictures that we had. You can even look at the quality of the pictures from when we first started up until now. You know, it's a big difference, but it's just been, like I said, it's been a humbling experience, man. We've had a lot. We've endured a lot. We have made a lot of strides, and we just keep looking forward to doing more and more. Mm-hmm. I'm excited.
Me too.
Absolutely. Like, you think about it, it's like, dang, so 5 years ago, yeah. And a lot of times I will, from time to time, just kind of tell people how Westside Misfits even became Westside Misfits.
Well,
I just do that at the intro so that, you know, just so I could tell how the idea, because it was really an idea. So when first I put it on Facebook that about having a podcast or show, and would anybody tune in or support us? And we had got a lot of feedback. That was in 2014.
Okay.
And we got a lot of feedback, and Shantae said, "Well, if you do it, I can help you."
Mm-hmm.
So she said we could come together and just kind of see what we could come up with.
Okay.
Not even. It was maybe even, now my brother Jasper wasn't on Facebook, but it was maybe about a few months after that, Jasper asked me, he said, "Man," he said, you don't want to do a blog? And I said, "Jasper, I don't even look at TV. You know what I'm saying? So how would I do a, like, what I'm going to be blogging about?" He was like, "Man, anything, really." He was like, "You ain't got to necessarily look at TV. Just look at, if you have to look at
social
TV,
media,
just, yeah." And I was like, "Man, I don't really know." Because at the time, I wasn't even into social media like that. Like, I had pages, but from what I could see now in these memories, I wasn't posting about nobody but mama and the children. So I'm like, "Well, I don't really know." So as time progressed, he came to me one last time, and he said, "Well, I'm just going to be honest with you. I think that's something that you can do. You know, you ain't never really had no interest in the music industry, but you like music." He was like, "I think you should go for it."
Why not?
And I think it was a few months after that, I ended up asking Dos Nada. I was like, "Man, what you think about doing a radio show?" And he was like, "What kind of radio show?" I was like, "Shit, I don't really know." And he was like, "A radio show?" And I'm like, "Yeah, remember we were right over there on Canova, yep." And I was like, "Yeah," I said, "well, shoot." Shantae said she'll jump in.
We ain't know what we're doing. All we do, we'll get drunk and high.
Right.
Like, that shit was crazy.
Like, for real. And we were sitting there over at Mama's house, how we came up with the name. We were sitting over at Mama's house like, "Well, what all of us got in common?" And we was like, well, we all from the West Side. BJ was there, like, it was, I even went to BJ and was like, "Well, BJ, you want to join in with us?" You know what I'm saying? And he was like, "Yeah, okay, so that'll make two boys, two girls." So I was like, "Yeah, cool." So we was like, "Well, shit, we all from the West Side." I mean, then we was like, "So, yeah, we definitely want to put something with the West Side in there."
Right.
And then I don't even know how we came up with Misfits. It just came out of nowhere. And we was like, "West Side Misfits? Oh, that's it, yeah!" Like,
that'll work.
And when we thought about it, we was like, really, yeah, we are all from the West Side, but we all have different experiences and different walks of life that do make us kind of, misfits when it comes to certain things. So we was like, that fit perfect. And a couple of weeks later, I think it was like a couple of weeks later, we pitched it to one person, one station, and they was like, they didn't really bite. Mm-hmm. And so Shantae suggested we go to another station, which is the station we started out on. And we went down, and he was like, "Hey."
You can say his name. Say the name of the station.
So,
New Radio.
I know I can say it. Y'all can say it. I ain't got
to say
it. I'm going to say
it. New Radio. Shout out, Move B.
So we... she pitched it to him, and he was like, "Hey, let's try it." He was like, "I'm willing to try it." And that's where it began. Like, we was like, "All right." Well, at the time, Sporadic, Nelson Trimble was working on a play that we had committed to working on with him. It was a stage play. I can't even remember the name of it right now, but it's in my memories too. I'll go back and look at it. But, so we was working on that, and we was like, "Well, his stage play is going to drop on August the 1st, so we could just start August the 2nd.
Mm-hmm.
And we was like, "All right." He was like, "August the 2nd it is." So, we squared everything away with him, and August the 2nd we showed up. And our very first guest on the West Side Misfits show was the cast from Sporadic Stage Play.
Yep.
And that's exactly how we did it, man. We started out, be honest with you,
We ain't have a DJ.
We didn't even know we needed no DJ. No idea what was going on.
And then a year or so later, she tell me about it.
That wasn't even a year.
No, I don't think it was a full year. Cause
one of you.
Cause we was having.
It could have been. Cause I know we was going through a lot of guests. DJs,
yeah, we were having guest DJs. We were just
and I think you even came on as a guest one time.
You did. He did. Yeah. He came on as a guest DJ one time, and I think that's what it was. I reached out to Rika to see if you wanted to come on as a guest DJ. That's exactly what I did, because I think I was sitting there and I was thinking about it, and I was like, Lab, be DJing. Yeah. You said who? Right. Yeah, wow. And it was so crazy because it was like a light bulb moment because I remembered you DJing. Because I remember one time me, you, and Rika, we had all met up at Aquarius Lounge, and I was like, that's something that we can, that me and you could do, because, you know, I was always been bartending, and I was like, so, you know, that way we can offer a package. Mm-hmm. And it was something that kind of like dinged and was like, ask Rika, what the hell DJ Lab got going on Sundays?
Mm-hmm.
And I asked her, she said, I asked him to see what he said.
Right.
Yeah. And
got
you
a
came
DJ
in.
And a producer. Yeah.
All at the same time. Yeah. Right. And so, you know, the thing about it is, man, in this industry, like you come across so many people. And when we all figured out we all had a common bond on liking good music.
Definitely.
That's all like that we figured out, like that was kind of what we needed. Like, we want to see people prosper in this business. We want to listen to good music, even if it's not by a well-known artist or an artist that's, you know, not a mainstream artist or whatever. Mm-hmm. We still appreciated good music.
Yeah, definitely.
And that common bond just kind of helped us out. We actually stuck with New Radio for, what, 2.5, almost 3 years?
Damn near 3 years.
Damn near 3 years we stayed down. And due to irreconcilable differences, we ended up separating.
Well, due to growth.
And, due to growth and just differences. Like, we don't know. We don't really know what happened, but at least I don't. But however, it was okay because.
I know.
Yeah, for real. Like, that's what I'm saying. But whatever happened, it was needed for us
to grow.
To grow definitely. And to actually pour into. What we could deliver a better and bigger platform for what we had a love for.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I say, you know, a lot of people look at situations like that and can't really overcome them or can't understand them. It wasn't even for us to understand because still to this day, I don't understand it and don't give a fuck about understanding.
Think about how much more we all have learned
exactly.
about what's going on.
Right.
That's you know. Exactly about. Well,
I mean,
about
we introduced video over there.
Remember? Absolutely.
We introduced video. Yeah. And it was
absolutely.
Yeah, we introduced video and streaming the video.
And going and just being live and just because the kind of support that we received from day one, I'm going to be honest with you, was huge for us because in all honesty, we didn't have a clue as to where we wanted to go or what we wanted to do. And that's why when you came into the midst of everything that was going on, it was easy for you to come in and make suggestions and do things because it wasn't no situation like that. We didn't know.
Right.
With you being knowledgeable, we could appreciate you saying, let's do it this way or let's do it that way, because if it worked, it worked.
Right.
If it don't, then we can all come together and say, let's do something different.
Right.
But we appreciated that input.
You know, the only thing I miss about that time that we was over there, I miss when people used to call in the show. And we were in there with the call.
Oh, yeah.
That's the only part I miss
that
about
back.
That.
We working on that.
Yeah, we got to get that back.
We going to get that back.
Because that was something
huge.
It may
be a case of where people call in on the Zoom and we talk to them
that
way.
That might be dope, yeah.
We going to work it out.
Y'all remember that, though, how people would call in and we'd be interacting? And all
I've been thinking about that last couple of weeks. Like, if I put the Zoom up there, maybe we get people call in on the Zoom. And talk to us that way.
Oh,
you
that
know?
Might be dope. Yeah.
Yeah.
And still, baby, like
we
film.
Did the young lady who we called that.
Oh yeah.
Oh okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We like we could put the Zoom info out, the password, and the connection.
Yeah.
And be like, put it on Facebook and Instagram. Be like, if y'all want to talk to us, give us a call. Mm-hmm.
Right. Right.
And then Donna could pick who she want to talk to because the names would be on there.
Okay.
Damn
yeah.
Everybody has Zoom. They got free version, so it's not like it's gonna cost you anything.
Yeah. To do it.
And
yeah.
you could be on a free version for 45 minutes. You know what I'm saying? They're not gonna talk to us for 45 minutes.
But so Zoom ain't free.
Zoom free.
Some
up
of
to
it
a,
is
up to 45 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We pay for it because our shows are 2 hours. So at the time when we were doing quarantine, it was cutting us off.
Okay.
Yeah, so we have to pay for it.
Yeah. Oh, it's not really expensive, to be honest with you. It's actually
it's
reasonable.
For everybody else. 45 minutes, if people get Zoom and want to talk to us and call in, talk to us, they could because it's free.
Okay.
So it's not gonna cost them anything and they're not gonna talk to us for no whole 2 hours.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? We're gonna be picking and choosing. It's nice talking to y'all. Go to the next person. So we might implement it that way.
I think that'd probably be the
least expensive way because we looked at getting the phone line and all the other stuff and it was just a lot expensive. Too much,
yeah. Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
A lot more going on. Yeah. But yeah, we'll work it out though. I feel pretty good about it, and the Zoom is not a bad idea at all.
Yeah.
Because the quality is usually good, that you can hear, you know, so all of that really matters. I see you got on your BMU shirt today. Yeah,
Black Men United.
So what happened yesterday? Did you go to the did you go to the meeting that they had yesterday?
I was actually live streaming it.
That's what's up.
I went there and live streamed.
That's why it looked so good.
Yeah.
I was wondering about that because I was like,
I saw some of the footage. Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, okay.
I live streamed and gave them the audio, the speakers and the board and stuff, so they can have audio.
Mm-hmm.
But I did live stream before.
That's what's up. Yeah. So you're an honorary member of Black Men United?
Yes.
I love it.
Okay, well,
I love it.
Explain us what that is. Like, right
it's now. Just Black Men United is a group of men trying to do things to better their community and the youth, to help the youth along.
Okay.
It's kind of like what I was trying to start before.
Okay.
But it's just Black men trying to help the community grow, get better, figure out things to help us as a people, collective, financially, as far as the law is concerned. Like yesterday's event was, we had a lawyer. And then
absolutely.
We had Poochie, who's financial,
mm-hmm.
trying to show you how to invest your money, how to do things better, get your credit better. Okay. Then the lawyer was explaining to you certain things about the law, the Constitution, and things of that nature. So
what happened if you get pulled over?
What happened if you get pulled over, stuff like that. So it was just about trying to help the youth understand certain ins and outs of what they're going through, you know, the country and the laws and the finance, how to make sure that when you get older, you know, everybody want to blow and spend money, but you got to figure out how to make sure that you have enough money to survive off of,
right?
You know, until when you get older. So it's things of that. It's about stuff like just growing, learning, teaching. Each one, you know, stuff like that.
So you guys had a good pretty good turnout.
We had a decent turnout for really not for kind of be a last minute deal.
Okay.
I think next event will be bigger and better.
Absolutely.
But it was a pretty decent.
Yeah, because I had just saw Chris put it up only about a few days ago.
Yeah. So it was a good little turnout for what we had going on. Mooley came. He was there.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it was a pretty. Yeah, so it was a pretty good event. I mean,
what did they say about getting pulled over by the cops on here? What did they say you should do? Like, what's the main
focus? The guy was talking, Poochie asked him, it wasn't Poochie. It was Dewan. Mm-hmm. Asked him, so what do you think the kids should do if they get pulled over by police? Should they just go ahead and shut up and take the ticket and fight it later, or should they?
You definitely don't fight it on the side of the road.
You
know,
yeah, or do you
no justice on the side
talk
of the road.
About, you know, I know my rights and stuff like that. You know, I can't really say if he really answered the question 100%. I'm going to take from it that he's saying just go ahead and take the ticket. And
you
work
have
and
no
try
choice.
To fight it later because you're not going to win anything on the side. That's
hell
what I'm going to
no.
take from it.
You do, you're not.
Right.
And
right.
He wouldn't have had to tell me that. Let me tell you something.
Growing up
black in America,
mm-hmm.
you learn some shit that other people don't even have to speak on or tell you about.
Right.
And the reason why I say that is because, you know, even with us, even with naming our children, we have to do that shit strategically.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So, like, growing up black is totally different. The very first thing I told my children when they started to drive was you don't fight on the side of the road about no ticket.
Right.
You take the ticket, fight in court. You got a better chance of winning. You got a chance of the motherfucker not even showing up.
And a better chance of getting home alive.
Exactly, and a better chance of living through it.
Cause I don't got tickets before. I knew I didn't deserve.
Right.
The officer knew I didn't deserve. But you know what you do. You
but they under smile. Under an immense amount of pressure too, to a certain extent, because they got to meet a quota.
Right.
So you have to be mindful that, you know, certain times of the month, just being honest with you, you more likely to get pulled over.
Right.
And it's just, that's just what's going on, especially if a person ain't been doing that now. A lot of them might be last minute.
Right.
Like, damn, I ain't right with 2 tickets last week. Let me get 10 this week.
I told the last time I got a ticket for running the stop sign, right? And now I see the police. I see the dude. Stop sign, I stop. Bust right. He pulled him over, so he gave me, tell him, looking at him, I'm like, hey, man, what y'all got going on? He say, you ran through that stop sign. I say, I saw you sitting there, officer. I stopped. I say, he say, hey, man, we got something special going on. Just wrote the ticket and left. I got right to court, told him exactly what was going on. They just threw it right out of court.
Yeah. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, you got a better chance. But don't be trying to.
I'm watching you at the stop sign.
Let me tell you something. I got a ticket one time for running a stop sign. The man said all 4 of my tires didn't stop.
So
I said, look, that's what I said. I said, well, how many will stop? I'm saying, when you pull up to a stop sign, all 4 of your tires got to come to a complete stop. I said, we went on Delmar Line. I was like, you right, sis-ass cop. Go on and give him a ticket. That's what I'm thinking to myself. Go on and give him a ticket. But.
Yeah,
but exactly. I need for you to put all of, but he didn't even show up in court.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Most of them never show up, bro.
He didn't even show up in court because he knew that sounded crazy as hell. I
think they'd be obligated
all
to write 4,
all 4 of your tires supposed to stop. I'm like, well, if I stop,
you won't spill it.
I was exactly. I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah,
like, it just sounded crazy. And I was like, all right, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't finna debate with him about nothing like that. Like,
you never can win an argument on the side of the road.
Like, mm-hmm. For real. I got stopped in DeKalb County one time. The dude said I was speeding through a school zone.
Mm.
But the craziest shit was, it wasn't no damn school around. So I was like, I said, well, man, I'm thinking to myself, maybe I missed the sign that say school. Because, you know, usually got a school zone sign. So I'm like, maybe I missed the sign. Man, I went back around that block 3 times after I got that ticket. Bullshit you not. It wasn't even a school zone. I got the court. They threw it out. It wasn't even no school zone.
Mm.
I was like, I said, maybe I'm tripping. Maybe I'm high. Let me go back around this block. I went around the block 3 times. No school zone signs. I got to court the very first time I went to court, they rescheduled it.
Right.
The second time I went to court, they just threw it out. Because, like I said, it's not a school zone. So when I told them that at the first one, they was like, we got to, you know,
check into it.
Yeah, so we'll reset the day. I'm like, cool. But it was just the whole point of, like, partner, you wasted 30 minutes of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know, maybe he thought I ain't had no license or something.
I'm telling you, a lot of times, like, what I realized here, because I used to get pulled over a lot when I used to drive the truck with the tent. Like, they would pull me over, and they just be wanting to see who in the car.
Right.
You know.
But
They gave me 10 tickets. I just go to court, and they check the tent, be like, this tent legal. But, mm-hmm. they just want to do it. You know,
right.
they want to see who in the car, see what's going on, and every time they do, how you doing?
A lot of times they just hope you're just going to pay it and not even go to court.
Yeah.
And a lot of times they do, man.
I'm the court man.
I'm showing up. Fuck that. Hey, I got stopped in Riverdale one day. Look, the car I was driving was in my mama's name.
Okay.
My mama's birthday on August 15th. I got pulled over on the 16th. This nigga gave me a ticket for an expired tag.
Mm.
I said, bro, really?
Listen, they so tough in Riverdale, they told me my car was stole. Look. My car, I only had 3 years. They told me it was stolen. You know what I did?
What?
I got right up out of that motherfucker. I said, oh, okay, I'm finna tow it. I got up and walked. It was a liquor store. Because I was I walked in the liquor store. I got I had a illegal contraband in my goddamn pocket. I was just having to get up out of the damn. I said, oh, my car stole. I said, okay.
Wow.
Look, I got out of there, right? They're going to tell me later. Now, take in mind now, they done impounded my car.
Right.
Told me it was stolen.
Right.
They're going to tell me, it's my fault. We had invalid information on your VIN number.
You remember that did me like that?
They told me my shit was stolen. I ain't give a damn. I was like, okay, long thing trying to frisk me and check me.
They did me like that in Atlanta, though. They did me like that on right down Cascade.
Mm.
The VIN number came up wrong or something. Boy, I got out that car and got, I was on my way to work. That always reminded me to keep some extra shoes in my car. I ain't lying.
Some walkers.
Hell yeah, some walker shoes. But I threw on my flip flops and got the hell on. I was like, if the car stole, I don't need. And I knew it wasn't stolen, but it was just the point of how they harassed me. I went and called BJ. I was like, hey man, come get me. I'm on Cash KD. Folks talking about their car stole. Get. Now they took the car.
Right.
Like they always do.
We'll just let you call a ride. Mm-hmm. I'm like, all right. So BJ came and got me. I'm trying to figure out, like, why. Come to find out, he talking about it was a mix-up on the VIN number.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but who fault is that? So right. Now I got to pay to get my car out of impound. Like, it was just too, I'm like, you know what?
I think they inconvenience people life on some bullshit.
Yeah, like, crazy.
And you still be responsible for the
See,
the
that's my whole thing.
Yeah.
That you still be responsible for the financial part of it when it clearly, because I kept saying my car stole. Then I'm thinking, mama, you remember the green Taurus?
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, who the hell mama bought this car from?
Right.
Like, she said it was from the church. But I
laid it from the church.
I ain't want to get shot. Somebody trying to argue with them about the car not being stolen because I don't know where she got the car from for real.
Right.
So I was like, I hopped up out of there on my work bag. Them boy, when I say the police were laughing so hard, I said, all right, see y'all. I guess I'll meet y'all at down Empire. I don't know what we're doing.
Right.
At this point, because I don't think the car stole, but like I said, they ended up throwing the ticket out. They had gave me some kind, I don't even know what kind of ticket they gave you.
They gave me a ticket for tag.
Registration. Yeah, that was mine.
All kind of shit.
Yep.
But the moral of the story is you can't win out there.
Hell
no,
I wasn't finna argue with them about no car being stolen. They gonna let me go on and they won't take me to jail. They was gonna let me walk to get my ride. I was like, all right, like I'm not finna go back and forth with you.
It's always every time I had this spirit, it's always some bullshit. When they tell you to step out the car,
oh man,
I ain't never stepped out the car. There wasn't no bullshit.
Got back in.
When you hear that step out the car, as a black man getting pulled out,
or a black woman,
hey,
watch your head.
Hey man, let me tell you,
and get ready for the ride.
Your
why?
Heart get the beat because you already know it's gonna be. Why I got to step out the car for a fucking traffic stop?
Yeah,
right.
Like, and the first time shit happened to me though, it was so crazy. Right, the first time, I don't know no goddamn better. You know, I step right out with my pen like I'm finna sign a goddamn thing. I step out that motherfucker.
Right.
He said, step to the back of the car. I'm thinking I'm finna sign a ticket. That motherfucker beat my ass.
Right.
Yeah, he fucked me over, but. I said, it's some bullshit. Ever since then,
I hear that
step out the car, be like, man.
Yeah,
damn.
Like we already know it fit well.
Please
don't
hit me, sir.
Right.
Like, I know y'all.
Right.
Bro, some of them police be really on some
bully.
They be on some bully and they be wanting you to resist. They want you to speak up and try to ask what you're getting pulled up. They love all that. So sir, what are you pulling me over for? And let me see your ID. See, they don't want to answer no questions. They want your ID. And I be like, man. I tell anybody, be careful when they say step out the car.
Going down.
Don't step out the car. Ask for somebody to supervise or something.
Yeah, you can try
now,
that too.
This day and time, don't step out the car. Like when, like the 90s and the early 2000s, we ain't know no better.
Right.
Yeah,
we were stepping out the car happily, getting the shit slapped out of them. We were like, God damn, officer. Hell, you hit me like that far.
Right.
Spread your legs.
Like, what?
Goddamn spread. Boop, 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 boop.
Right. Like, nigga, you didn't give me enough time to spread them.
Yeah, that's crazy. You can laugh because you, hey, but think about the people who never came back from that experience and step out the car. That's the last shit that, like.
Right.
And then as they whooping your ass, they holler, quit resisting.
Right.
And it's like,
motherfucker, you can't. I can't block. You can't block, motherfucker.
Like,
hey, that's like when you little, you know, you get a whip from your mom. If you try to block, that's like fighting back.
Right.
All
she
that
gonna
goddamn,
tell everybody.
All that, you fight. Oh, she tell everybody. The motherfucker was fighting.
Fighting back.
No, I was blocking them motherfucking reflexes.
Exactly.
Like, goddamn.
Right.
That's just how it is, but. Man, like for real, like I think we could actually write a book about the experience. I tell anybody, like my most memorable experiences happened between Adamville and Bankhead. All different work. Like, seriously.
Basically.
I think, like, for real, we could really, like, write a book about experiences. Because what I realized is a lot of the experiences that encounters that I've had with my friends that ain't really from the West Side or from some, you know, from different sides, they ain't really had that. So it was only right that either I learned from those experiences or continue to deal with them. You know what I'm saying? Until I learned them, but like I learned a lot of stuff like right from the beginning. Like, right. Soon as it happened, I was like, "Woo, won't do that no more." Yeah. I don't got to feel everybody. That no more. That shit hurt.
It only take one time.
Yeah, right? I'm one of them kind of people. And I'm gonna tell you something. I'm also one of them kind of people where I can look at another person's experience and be like, I don't want that.
Right.
You know, a lot of people have to learn from experience. I ain't got the experience to know. I don't want.
You know the difference. Smart people learn from their own experiences. Wise people learn from the experience of others.
Seriously.
You can go through it and that stove hot and you know what?
Right.
It is hot.
Right.
She told me it's hot for real.
Right.
You can look at it and be like, she said hot. Yeah, that motherfucker look. I was just gonna say,
it look like
it look a little hot, right?
Yeah, that motherfucker look red. Yeah. Like. Okay, no, I ain't got to tell you that. Like, I'm one of them kind of people. I ain't got the experiences, y'all, to know that it ain't right. But look, so earlier today, I'm just going to tell y'all, we're going to go into a break. So earlier today, I had put up a post on Facebook. I shared it from my homeboy page. He was like, now that we grown, y'all going to tell us why y'all were letting these niggas run trains on y'all.
Ooh.
So I was like, you know what? That is a good question. And I want people to hit my inbox with the answer. Because it was a lot of that stuff going on when we was young.
Yeah.
I almost got locked up trying to defend somebody about the shit. Because I thought it was a gang rape. Only to find out she was volunteering. I was like, bitch, I almost shot 4 people for you. And you volunteering?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Like, that serious.
That shit have more, y'all, more than people realize.
But that made me learn how to stay in my own lane, though. That one experience helped me learn how to stay in my own lane and don't be meddling in folk business. Because it wasn't that I was meddling in her business. I was just down.
Right.
So, I'm like, that don't really look safe.
Right.
Mm-hmm. What we doing here? What's going on? See, but had somebody prepared me and told me then what was going on, well, I would have just left.
I ran with a crew of niggas. We used to call ourselves the Cock Ninjas.
Oh, yeah.
The Cock Ninjas. So, shout out to them Cock Ninjas. Y'all know who y'all love. Y'all tuned in.
And look, check this out. I got a homeboy that did a training. I mean, he was a part of the train. And the girl ended up pregnant.
He rode the caboose?
Yeah.
The caboose?
And the
engine.
Either they weren't using condoms, son having the girl end up pregnant, and he was the daddy. So he was like the talk of the.
I wasn't going.
The
bastard babe
of 100
men. I ain't do no trains when I was young. I ain't gonna go behind all them nasty motherfuckers. No, hell no. Hell no.
He's talking about hell no.
Some of them motherfuckers in my neighborhood.
See, cause that's the difference between the knowing and the not knowing.
Hell
see,
no.
It's certain folks I ain't going behind.
There was some motherfuckers had girlfriend that was questionable, so I know I wasn't finna go behind no training these motherfuckers.
Exactly.
Hell
up to
no.
Even as a woman, it's some men that have been knocked completely off my dating roster. Because of who they used to deal with.
And I don't tell
them. I just be like, you know, nah, I'm okay. You know, like, I let them down real easy. But
I know your whole facts.
Right. I be like, whew, boy.
I ain't do none of that shit, man. I guess that's why my sexual number so low. Because I look at these niggas in my neighborhood and be like, nah.
He's talking about, nah.
These niggas don't even wash their hands.
Right. Know what the hell they're going on. Like, bro, no.
Nah, these niggas don't even wash their hands. I know I ain't finna go behind them sexually. Hell no.
But like, yeah.
You ain't gonna wash your hands before you eat that hamburger, bro?
Right.
You done played in the mud. We done played softball. We done played strike them out. We done played football. We done did some old other shit. We done been mud pies in the sand. And you eating
the
hamburger.
And them the ones surviving corona. Right? Yep.
Hey, did y'all, man, I'm gonna tell you the funny shit. I was listening to the radio the other day, right? Second date update. Y'all be looking at on.
Sometime.
No, I ain't
dude, girl called and she was tripping because she was dating. She met a dude and they was having sex. But she was mad because the nigga wouldn't take off his mask. Nigga wouldn't take off his face mask and his gloves.
Uh-huh.
And then she gonna holler, but the nigga didn't want to wear no rubber.
Oh.
So he in there fucking with gloves on and a mask on and no rubber. Man, I was laughing so goddamn well.
What?
Said,
but she letting him fuck with no rubber.
That's what I'm saying. So she was mad. She was just like, how you gonna be trying to have sex with no rope, with no condom, and you got on these gloves at the face? Man, I thought that shit was so funny. I said, man, this is.
Wonder how long business. They had been together since before COVID.
Nah, these niggas out here meet new. Man, I know niggas meet new women.
Man, I know.
Corona
season. Hell yeah, I know a lot of folk meet new
time
people.
Of their life.
Hey, let me tell you something. I just when we come back, we're gonna talk about this too. I just was telling I don't know what to call it, but however. I was telling her that when it comes to dating, not sexing, I said, but dating, like, you can, like, if you're trying to figure out if a person is worthy of you dating them, you got the problem. Like, you may have to date more than one or two people. Not sex.
Dating is
but
dating. Dating is dating. Kicking
but see, that's the difference. A lot of motherfuckers don't know the difference.
They right, no so that's what she said.
They
she
think
said,
sex
"Well,
is all attached to dating. Like
no,
you go out with a motherfucker a few times, you gonna fuck. It ain't got. I'm telling you, a lot of motherfuckers older don't know the difference.
That's true too. But that's what I was telling her. She was like, I said, because I mean, you know, it's peaches and cream at the beginning. Them lies, boy. What?
But them
lies be so confident and just sound so good.
Who,
like,
the whole lies or the nigga lies?
Both of them.
Everybody lies.
Both of them. Yeah. They just be over the top, and you be like, "But see, I'm pretty transparent."
I buy everybody lie though, and the reason I say that is you. Everybody tell lies at the beginning, so really it's hard to base a relationship with everybody lying. But you figure out through the lies. But do I want to start telling this motherfucker the truth? Or should I start telling her the truth? Or
see,
something?
I don't do everybody, good with lies. I ain't going to remember it. Yeah. See, I ain't got to worry about
they
remembering
got
the truth.
I've learned in the last few months, last year or so, my views on relationships and everybody else's views are different.
You know
so
why?
I'm just shutting
because
my mouth up.
Because you was in a committed relationship for so long.
Yeah, I just shut my mouth up now when it comes to relationship type shit because I'm just a different type of person, and I noticed that everybody else seemed to be on some other shit, so I just leave that shit alone.
Everybody is not on some
so
different
just
kind of shit.
Like, I just say,
But the idea of it, like, I honestly can't remember lies. See, I'm not going to remember it. So that's why I say for me personally, deadline, it won't work for me.
But that don't stop none of your motherfuckers from lying.
Right. But I be hearing the lies that the men tell me, and I be like, oh, gosh, that sounds so great. But I don't even tell them. Huh?
They don't care.
Man, let me tell you something. I don't even tell them that I know it's a lie. Like, I just be like, oh, okay. Like, I'm the old K lady. Like, I don't tell a nigga I know he lying.
You just let him think he's getting over.
Yeah, because more than likely, see, my thing is if you lie about little shit, it get worse. So so it's kind of like, I know we ain't finna do nothing but waste each other's time.
What else you lying
right.
About?
Yeah. See, that's my thing.
Lie about shit you ain't got to lie about. Yeah.
But let me tell you, a dude, I never forget this. This did when I knew folk were going crazy. The nigga lied about how many kids he had.
What?
Now, the reason why I knew how many kids he had was because I knew somebody that
you
he knew.
You did the nigga hold fast. Go on and sit.
No, listen. Before, this was the thing. The person that introduced me to him
had already told me.
It wasn't even nothing like that. No, I'm like, yeah. So when he lied about how many kids he had, I was just like, oh boy, I know we finna waste the hell out of each other time. Like, this nigga do not even get a fair try. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, hell, you gonna lie about how many kids you got for? Like, that ain't, that's an unnecessary lie to me.
But he think it's gonna be a strike. If he tell you got 7 kids, that's gonna be a strike against him. It's a turn
off. Yeah. But how was that when I got 4? Everybody know how many children I got. That ain't no secret. I don't care nobody nigga knowing. Cause get what? They ain't looking for no daddy. So you feel what I'm saying? Like, and I definitely ain't finna try to be your kid's mama. So stuff like that to me don't make sense to lie about.
Well, he probably done told women that before. And time he said he had 7 children, they were like, oh, hell no.
I mean, but I don't even ask a whole lot of questions. My thing, well, I think I ended up asking him that question from something that we was talking about. So it wasn't.
So how bad was the lie?
I think he's.
How many of me left off?
Like 3.
Damn, he left off 3 whole kids?
Left off 3 kids. And I mean, was
you
like,
can have a lot of kids, but how many, like Ricky said, how many baby mamas you got?
Yeah.
What? How many kids is too many kids?
No.
It depends on what you're willing to deal with.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
I mean, how responsible a person you are.
That's how many baby mamas is too many?
Like, if you got 7 and you got 7 baby mamas, that's a lot.
That's a deal breaker.
That's a lot, man.
Oh, I mean, let me tell you something. I hardly even date men with kids. Like, so I don't really know. Like, I don't think I've ever dated nobody seriously with more than, like, I don't even think I ain't dated nobody with no. My kids was their daddy's first kids.
Right.
So I don't, I might have talked to somebody, but I never asked them about their children. Like, that wasn't.
Even Terry used to not date guys that got kids, but when she had 1, he would not date her again.
Started dating.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
So how can I tell you not to have
one? You got one.
But you know that can still be your preference, though. Like, because it's about preference. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That could be your preference. I don't care if you got 10 kids. Right. It could be your preference not to deal with a man with kids.
Right.
Now, it's whether
like
he.
Some men don't like women.
Yeah. Just like a man got a preference on. It's like with me, the little kids is who I'm tripping. Not really tripping about, but like, what the hell happened to you and their mama? And the children like 3 and 4. Like, the fuck? What happened with you and their mama? Like, where she at? Like, what y'all doing? You know what I'm saying? Like, that sounds like a headache.
Right? Shit happens, though, right?
Yeah.
Man, shit happens. But well, I'm going to tell you something.
You got to be tricked. You got
to
be
smart. Nigga tricked me to deal with him with some little bit of that chill like that because it's going to be some mess behind, like.
Well, I mean, but, like, if they, like, well. Mom passed away or something like that. That's different.
That's different.
Okay.
That's totally damn
prison.
Different.
Mm. She in prison
even
for selling
that's
drugs.
That ain't even different because she probably got a chance to come back.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
see that thing could work both ways because I ain't gonna like to be like that. I didn't really want to date women with kids. For that reason, because you don't want that response. You don't. I ain't never been nobody dated, so you know you be trying to like, I don't know. But then. And what happens is you meet somebody and you end up meeting the kids and the kid be cool and be like, oh, okay.
And then y'all break up with the kids still.
Or whatever, like you be like, man, and that could work because you literally fall for the kids. Like you be like, you know, so you be thinking more about them than the people. You be like, I want to do what's best for the kids and the kids this and that, you know. That
so
happens.
You
would have
been a better uncle for me, cause my uncles was like, shit, they got kids, they fucking. That's all my uncles used to say.
Oh, right.
So we know what they doing.
We already know what they
yeah,
are.
Yeah, yeah. That's all my uncles used to say, man. If they got kids, they fucking. Mm-hmm. That's all you get. That's all you need to know. Okay, hoes.
Bye. See, I don't know. I just I don't know.
My uncle's about that by women that smoke cigarettes. Every time he said one was serious, be like, ooh. Every time she pull a cigarette, he'd be like, ooh. I'd be like, what? He said, boy, you saw she pulling that cigarette, ooh. Shout out Bobcat. Bobcat something, man.
I think my uncles made me not want to have sex as much. Because what's the stuff they used to talk about sex? Oh, God.
Yeah, they probably ruined you.
Yeah, they ruined it, man. They ruined it. Like, I really don't want, you know what I'm saying? Like, Because they used to have sex with so many different women.
Oh, they was out there tripping.
They were out there tripping. You know, my uncles was like 6'2". They was athletic. They were doing everything.
What
you know?
The hell?
Yeah, my uncles was tall.
Who, like, well, who's short?
My mama's the oldest.
And she's short.
Everybody. And she's shorter than everybody. My grandmama's short. My grandfather.
Oh,
tall.
Okay.
My grandfather was like 6'6".
Oh, okay.
300-something pounds. So all my uncles was tall.
Okay.
Even two of my aunts was tall. Like my auntie Angie, who passed away a long time ago, she was 5'9". My auntie Vicky, 6 feet. You know what I'm saying? So everybody was tall, except for my mama. She got my grandmama's size. So it's like, you know.
Yeah. Okay, I'm like, well, who the hell
yeah,
short?
Yeah, my uncles was like 6'4", 6'2".
My old uncle, close my age, I learned by sex from his ass. He was screwing everybody in Atlanta felt like.
You're like, damn, you knocking them off too, bruh?
Yeah,
my uncle was fucking everybody in Chicago. I'm sure of it.
He's talking about
I'm sure of it.
You see them coming in and out the house? Like, how you knew?
Had a basement with a separate entrance.
And they had
their own little room down there in the basement. So, you know, when they got a little bit older. But it was I would go places with them and they would go pick up girls. And then all of a sudden they'd be like, man, we finna go to, they used to call me Shorty, we finna go to the Forest Preserve, man. And they put this sheet up between the back seat and the front seat. And I'd be in the front seat. Fucking in the back seat.
Oh, hell no.
And you sitting there like, whoa.
They used to always take me with them. You know what I'm saying? Like, they used to always
you
take
the
me
alibi.
With them.
You were like, you
I
were
was
like,
probably the alibi. Yeah. They used to always
we
take
taking
me.
Lead.
Knowing damn
well.
Always take me with them. Then when they got their own cars, because they used my grandfather's car. When they got their own cars, oh, Jesus Christ.
It got even worse.
Yeah, it got even worse. It got even worse. Then the two that's twins went to Marines. I'm sure for a while until he got married, he probably fucking everybody in the Marine.
Let me tell you something, which is very, very normal. I didn't know that until later on in life.
What?
All the people in the military be screwing each other, especially when they deploying, like if they on ships and all that kind of stuff. What? I was like, what?
Y'all don't get a break?
Yeah, we can.
Look, Rick is talking about I got a grandchild out of there.
Why? Oh.
My son was in the Navy, and Calvin Mom was in the Navy, too. But they was on the same ship.
Oh, yeah. That's a good recipe.
Right.
We out here in their water? This shit don't count? Come on.
Right. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
We're international waters.
Let me say something. You know, folk always trying to figure out a reason why it don't count.
That's why I need to go out of town and cheat. I wasn't even in Atlanta. I was goddamn way, goddamn.
Right. Down didn't count.
Like,
what? How the hell? You sure? Get us in the mix, DJ Lab. Well, look, Doznado.
What's up?
Why do you think women would be letting men run trains on them?
I think it's a self-esteem issue. Honestly, look, man, hey. It's a self-esteem issue or how they were raised or who brought it to them like, or how it was brought to them. Y'all be surprised,
how
man.
Do you present,
it's a lot of women.
How do you present a train? Like, what's the
okay.
etiquette for presenting
well,
a train?
Well, what happens is it's a setting. You know what I'm saying? Everybody kicking it. And one thing lead to another. And it's like we all having fun. I mean, it ain't no particular way it happens. It just happens. Okay, let me.
You already know she gonna.
Listen, I'm gonna tell you the first time I ever seen that happen though.
In Harris Homes.
One Sunday, I swear for God, we at Maddox Park. At Maddox Park, just kicking it. These white girls riding around in a Jeep,
like a
Wrangler. No, listen, I'm gonna tell you exactly what happened. This first time, this is where the cut up shit. When they talk about cutting up and all that shit, got me some cut up and all that bullshit. Come back, so the girl, they talking to the girl. We in the park, we just sitting, everybody smoking, drinking. They said, well, shit, we finna go back over to her home. The girls come to the apartment, everything, right? I remember one of the girls saying she had just got out the military, and they were here from Tennessee. You get what I'm saying? So it was two of them. So I'm like, damn, so you know, I ain't never seen, honestly, I ain't thinking that finna happen. You know, I'm thinking, you know, I ain't never seen no shit like this happen before. So I'm just sitting there. One of the girls go upstairs. So me and two more dudes, we sitting downstairs just talking to, this is how we found out information about the girls. You know, they out the military, bim, all this shit. So we just sitting there. We don't know what the fuck going on upstairs. We just sitting down there talking. So all of a sudden, we hear some dudes laughing. So I'm like, damn, what the fuck going on? So this dude like, dad, let's go see what the fuck going on up here. The girl standing in the middle of the goddamn, the girl standing in the middle of the bed. It's a big ass bed. She's standing in the middle of the bed getting undressed. So you know the niggas like, oh, hell yeah, they real with her. Go, right? So look, I heard this, I got the rules to the shit. I ain't even know no rules to the shit, right? One of the dudes was going to try to help the girl, you know, take her clothes off. Dude like, hell no. One of the dudes said, nigga, don't touch her. Let her take her own goddamn clothes off, right? Look, so I'm standing like, whoa. The girl gets naked. Like, by this time, so I'm like, oh, okay, this finna be, like, I know this finna be. Like, this finna be something that goddamn Achikashi Little Rachi. Right? So the dude was like, because, you know, dude finna try to help her, you know, get her clothes. He like, hell no, let her take her own goddamn clothes off. Don't touch her clothes. You know, so the girl, she dancing. All this shit, by that time, I said, oh, boy, I finna go. That was about four. Dude, by that time, they go to ease the niggas out of the room at this point. It's too many niggas in the room. So now they're like, hey, we finna close, you know, we finna close the door. I said, oh, shit. So that, like, that's the first time I ever seen some shit like that. I couldn't believe it, because, you know, I'm thinking, I'm like, man.
So the other girl wasn't with it, just the one on stage.
Eventually she got with it. I got the hell on. I went back down there. She went asking about her friend. I said, she upstairs dancing and stuff. And she was like, for real? She said, she was like, can I go up there too? I said, shit, I don't care. You know, help yourself. She walk up there. They got it. They wouldn't let her in the room. She knocking on the door, DVV. I want to come in. By this time, I'm standing there looking. I said, you know what? By say about 10 niggas in the house. I said, I think about
that's
time.
My cue.
My time. But when I seen that shit, I said, man, they signed right, like they, it wasn't nobody grabbing nobody. And I was like, what the fuck? I couldn't believe it. I'm sitting there like, this shit really go down.
Yeah, they signing up for it.
Yeah.
So you think it's like self-esteem issues or?
I think that's a rape culture. I think that's part of the hip hop and the, like, now if some shit like that happened,
hey, some of y'all
niggas going
Facebook,
to jail, huh?
Tell us why they y'all at with.
Nah, for real. I'm just
like, for some shit like that now, I think back on shit like that.
Right.
Like, that shit rapey as a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But that shit happened.
But even if they volunteer, is it rapey?
I just don't know.
I don't think it's rapey.
Me personally, I just don't know why another nigga would want to go behind another nigga who going behind another nigga who went behind another nigga. I just don't.
What you mean? It's fun, they say.
It's a train. That's what they call it, the train.
Choo-choo.
It ain't that fun.
Choo-choo. You ready to laugh?
I don't think it's that fun. Okay.
I guess it depends on what part of the train. If you're on the engine part of the train, or you come in at the caboose.
Hey, them little cars ain't all that spectacular either, man.
I suggest you get in on the engine.
Because when she in the front car and nutted, and the middle car, and then you got the other two cars or three cars. When she getting up to go wipe herself?
She ain't.
Man,
so
them
you got all them. You got all that nigga juices all over you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to go to some meals again because we just hit a, yeah. Let's get some meals again. Jesus.
Intoxicating your eardrums. Mixologist DJ Lab.
Mixologist.
We can take our time, ain't gotta rush a thing. Cause ain't nothing wrong with some foreplay. Got me licking your flesh until I make you rain. And when you at your peak, babe, just let me hear my name. Girl, you love.
You got the home field advantage. Don't make me eat you out of panties, baby. Don't rock my Titanic. Hold on and don't you panic, baby. You got me in a rush and I don't wanna buzz, cause I can't get enough. Let me drown in your love, mama. Eat a pussy up, mama. Beat a pussy up, cause I know you like it rough when I'm digging in your guts. It's going down in the air. And I'm about to run your basement. Let me dry your body crazy. Just hold on and stay faded.
Told me long time ago, you know, you can't keep it real with everybody. Most of these niggas is hoes, and most of these hoes for everybody. I'm not your average Joe, and my bag in this sack ain't for everybody. My haters get mad cause they broke. If it ain't by the dough, then fuck everybody.
Fat told me long time ago,
if it ain't by the dough, then fuck everybody.
Most of these niggas be hoes,
if it ain't by the dough, then fuck everybody.
I'm not your average Joe,
if it ain't by the dough, then fuck everybody.
These haters get mad cause they broke.
If it ain't by the dough, then fuck everybody.
Most of these niggas be hoes, you know. I just can't expose it. Everything glitter ain't gold, you know. Hey, yo, smell roses. Most of these niggas, they look the part. And I'm a Kool-Aid pumping out their heart. We don't mix well, I put that on guard. Ain't no sick man, I knew that from the start. Yeah, yeah, slime you before you slime me. Fuck me over, shit, found me. I'ma get you back, shit, time three. I'm a solid nigga, stand behind me. Never hid, you can find me. But I had to cut down a click. Most of them niggas want shit, you niggas want to
I got the sauce. You know a nigga flow. Bitch, I got the juice. They fucked up and let me loose. Bitch, I got a whole lot. All of this, a whole lot. Bitch, I got a whole lot. All of this, my own spot. Bitch, I got a lot of money, a lot of hoes, a lot of weed. Bitch, I got a lot of this, a lot of that. Bitch, you not, bitch, I got. Bitch, I've been working. Working like slaves. The only difference though, bitch, I get paid. Bitch, I get money. And then I get laid. Yo, ho, come over here. She ask, can she stay? No, gotta go. Cause my taste is for dough. Ain't got time for no hoes. Fuck that. I'm on the road.
I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise.
A lot of niggas play me to the left, now they get left. Yeah, fuck you, nigga. Run up on me, I'm a bunch of nigga. Fuck that friend shit, I don't trust you, nigga. Teamwork, man, the dream work, man, fuck that. These nigga word, I don't trust that. We ain't cool, get the fuck back. I'm better than these nigga, fuck being humble. Hit sticker, nigga, make his ass fumble. They the opposition, really ain't winning. Nigga looking funny with that prop money. 20K on a gram of 10 likes, nigga, how that shit add up. Many real niggas, real ducks. Many real niggas, like before. I want all the smoke, lil' yachty. Street niggas with their hustle sloppy. They baby mama giving sloppy toppy. Pouring champagne, watch it call me poppy. Fuck a nigga if he changed up. Cause a nigga done got it changed up. If you feel the way, can't check it, bitch. But trust me, nigga.
I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise hell on you pussy niggas. I'ma raise, I'ma raise, I'ma raise.
Go get the bag, go get the bag, go get the bag.
Go get the bag,
go get the bag, go get the bag, go get the bag. Hey, do you mad, do you mad, do you mad?
There's
so many cash, so many cash, so many cash. Go get the bag, go get the bag, go get the bag.
Go get the bag,
go get the bag, go get the bag. Hey, do you mad, do you mad, do you mad? So many cash, so many cash. The flyest of the flyers. You are rocking with the pilot. I'm too busy doing me. Getting to the cream, nigga. You should try it. Fuck with me, wrong. I might start a riot. Too money hungry, no, we don't die. Bitch, I'm flipping that word once I'm jumping down. Bricks it in my bed, won't people stop me? How you gon' fuck with a nigga like me? Nigga, can't even fuck with myself. Get hit with that Rico. This rap shit is free throw. I shoot that bitch from a block away. They call me stop. I let my money in love them out. My first and single made all these bitches bounce. Since she do it, I'll keep that bitch in the house. Nigga, know what it is when I come around. But you really don't know you. Put up a lot in the illest way. My whole clique is rugged, it's 200 stomachs. So please get the fuck out the dealership. Fuck up my niggas and be a mate. To the death of me, you know it's here, mate. Get into them shit, nigga, that's freedom late. I'ma get to that bag, nigga, in the way.
Talk like a hot ass bitch. Show us her sad like a teacher. Blessing her cat, I'm a preacher. Treat a little hoe like a skeezer. She park in the back of my Beamer. Rock a bag, go like Serena. Dog in that hoe like Sharkeisha. Treat her like shit, then I leave her. Talk that bitch hot ass bitch. Show us that say like a teacher. Blessing her cat, I'm a preacher. Treat the little hoe like a skeezer. She park in the back of my Beamer. Rack her back up like Serena. Dog in that hoe like Sharkeisha. Treat her like shit, then I leave her. I hit the studio, lay down and hit 33, he booming this shit. Hardest producer, he doing this shit. Underwater, I just flooded my wrist. Get in that pussy, she painted my shit. Deep throat, got a cave in her shit. Back and forth, suicide on that dick. Screaming frost when I bust on the tip. What you say? Bitch, stop playing. Leave you for Shauna, who driving no Hondas. But get it behind her, took me to Bahamas. That's word on my mama, go missing her summer. Be dog on my bombers to carry that llama. Bad bitch like Rihanna, she want a new Hummer. That bitch, she told me she want a new Hummer. That bitch, she told me she want a new Hummer. Yeah.
I pour the lean until it drip. I got lil' baby in my whip. And all the chicken make a script. Say fuck around, let's take a trip. See all these diamonds. changing the climate, trying to chill. They play around and you get flipped. Yeah, yeah. I got the 30 in my clip.
Chocolate chicks, sweet. They call her no sleep. Beat hard, beat hard. Kick it out, gently. He's got high space style. Top gun, NASA. I'm flying in a G4. She faster than a NASCAR. Pull up in my satellite. Flyer than a satellite. She know if she acting right, everything gon' be alright. I feel like I'm Kanye. Everywhere I look, it's flashing lights. I'm blowing cushy, blowing pipe. You don't do that, you ain't my type. Hi. So here I be in my spacesuit. I don't chase hoes like a pirate, bitch, I chase loot. All my dogs hungry, we will chop you up and plate you. Still hungry, nigga, so we ate your homie face too. Then jump back in my whip with my bad chick. Pull off in a cloud of smoke, then disappear like magic. Tom Cruise, Top Gun, fly with the top down. Whipping like a NASCAR truck, beating the block down. Bad chocolate sweet.
I spot the ice on the wrist. Yeah. I'm trying to freeze, I'm trying to flood. Swear so drippy, don't fuck up the gut. Grinding over, I don't made it a puddle. Been to the money, I never gonna struggle. Got the game locked in like a purse. I know that the nigga gon' fold under pressure. Pull up, doors open on the test. Fuck all that shit they be talking. Diamond dripping, yeah, coffee. Put the game in the coffin. Them bitches love it, they be stalking. Birds coming in, I'm stalking them up. Nigga come around, my boss and I'm out. I'm a real nigga, I don't give a fuck. I run a view when we more than a thug. Count 100,000 point in drug. I'm with Lil Timmy, he popping no winner. Shouts out to Russell, we having muscle. Keep the 40, I ain't down with the tussle. Caught through your hood around in the test. Throws up, flapping just like a pet. I'm on a mission, I'm chasing the chuck. Stack it up, I'm just like the compet.
Niggas wanna hate on me. Right on the king of the street,
on the
and I'm on bleeding. Shots out the key, pop me the air, ain't got time to shoot.
Yeah, listen,
got
what bitch, you
got a bless like a sneeze. Push start me, bitch, it ain't no key. I can get the gas if it ain't 93. Got a little bitch gon' suck me in the street. I spot the ice on the wrist. Yeah. I'm tryna freeze, I'm tryna flood it. Swag so drippy, don't fuck up the gut. Grinding over, I don't mean it a pop.
I won't dare listen what you say. Just go in when they press play. Life is a game with a paradise, and they latch on like parasites. Meal check like a paratite, no leggings. I work for this, no begging. Wasn't no plug, love. My shit wasn't getting played in the club. TLC, I was just scrubbing the patch side of my best friend ride. Writing rounds on my iPhone, these flows gon' get me on. I was writing rounds on my 30s, thinking the court to serving McFlurries. They told me keep my head out the clouds, my dreams too big for my bridges. My friends hooping and they getting bitches. Fuck Jordans, I'm buying speakers. Earning stripes like Adidas. A flow that can free the people like my. Did for the Maccabees. It's just me and my Mac and me and the soul. I spill in the closet, realizing nothing can stop me.
And it ain't nothing that can stop me now. And it ain't nothing that can stop me now.
Oh, kick it out, flame lightning.
And it ain't nothing that can stop me now. And it ain't nothing that can stop me now.
Swag boy, oh, that's a me show.
money, so I don't care if you don't like me. Thought that I should let you know. My eyes be low, cause I ain't sleeping. To keep my diamonds on me, tweaking. Meeny, meeny, money, mo. I'm getting to this money, so I don't care if you don't like me. Thought that I should let you know. My eyes be low, cause I ain't sleeping. To keep my diamonds on me, tweaking.
Holla, me. Fire red thing from the seats. Yeah, I'm with the sheets. Swallow all the dick. Give her cheek chills, but ain't licking no click. Man, y'all play too much. Wait, don't really care about all that talk. If you draw the line, I'ma walk that walk. Man, I'm so yummy, fat ass, real soft. Raw and uncut with a whole lot of sauce. Her say she don't like me. Me don't like me neither. I'm so focused on this new life. Be so high that I don't see him. I don't really know why they so pissed. I'm just trying to live and feed my jit. Queen of rap, man, that ain't shit. I just want my bag, we can all get rich. He said that he love my voice. I'm so focused on my bag. And ain't messing with a nigga. Let's that nigga dick say. Being at the bottom from my way to the tizzy. Gotta keep going, gotta get the trip from Drizzy. Coming through the city like a tsunami hit it. Tearing up shit for whoever didn't hit me. M-O-N-E, why won't plenty? Compete against who, ain't worried about any. You don't like it, better get with it. Eastside shawty, coming for the middle.
Any, many, money, mo. I'm getting to this money, so I don't care if you don't like me. Thought that I should let you know. My eyes be low, cause I ain't sleeping. To keep my diamonds on me, tweaking.
Or shoot the LA, spend a day in courtside with the Lakers. Or we can just ride to the tide, get a room in Vegas. She asked me what I do, I'ma tell her the truth. I'ma take her on,
I'ma take her
on, I'ma take her
on, I'ma tell her the truth.
I'ma take her
on, I'ma take her on. She asked me what I do, I'ma tell her the truth.
One day I wanna get married. My last name, I wanna share it.
Share.
Don't you wanna feel like a rabbit?
Don't you?
Walk around here for the carrots. It's been your best life. Be my wife with a horse and a carriage. The way I live life, I can't lie, baby, I'm a savage. I need a ride or die that won't get tired.
Be embarrassed.
When they ask you what I do, don't lie, just tell the truth. I'ma take her on.
I'ma take her on.
I'ma take her
on. I'ma tell her the truth.
I'ma take her
on. I'ma take her on. She asked me what I do. I'ma tell her the truth.
I'ma take her
on. I'ma take her on.
I'ma take her
on. I'ma tell her the truth.
I'ma take her
on. I'ma take her
on. I'ma take her
on.
Brothers, just stay down, yeah, we gonna eat. I told them, make sure that they keepin' their cage round. These niggas be creepin'. Smokin' my nigga, they stuck in the grave now. I just can't believe it. The nigga that called me, they really went playin' around. I just couldn't see it. Said if you love me, I knew you were capping. I only speak on the truth when I'm rapping. Play with the gang and we gon' get the blast. I didn't shoot, but for sure made it happen. I got a load of that stick. Nigga, they praying, they hoping I slip. Cuss on the fine, I got a tight grip. Nigga keep playing, he catching a rope. These niggas were watching my move. I ain't have a plan, make something out of nothing. Come from the jungle, I was really struggling. Got from my mama, learn how to hustle. Promise I'ma ride for my brother. Always keep a nine in the gutter. Lay him down, slide for each other. Really had to grind, had to suffer. I was only nine in the gutter. I told my bitch, let go get us a bag. Get what you want, no more checking the tag. They thinking I'm playing, I'm buying a jet. Soon as I tell me a couple more racks. We spinning your block with shots. We let them up by the 10.
Hey, man, I just had a chance to go through the books that we have with all the pictures and the memories and stuff.
Wow.
You
got a lot of pictures.
And what's so crazy is On those pictures, I could tell that my weight fluctuate. Like, I be fat, and then I be a little bit fat.
Okay.
It's really
sometimes
weird.
It just gotta fluctuate.
I know that it do that, because I could just tell by, you know, certain things that you wear and stuff like that. But that's what I know. I said that was really consistent.
Well, I can say I've been fat on every picture.
I've been fat on all of them, but like some of them I be fat.
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? It's a difference. It's a difference.
Got a lot of memories, though. I look at them pictures, man. I'm like, wow. We had a lot of guests, too.
Right,
a lot of people.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep. I was like, dang, okay, Ricky, you did your thing, boo. Do your thing, boo.
Right, right.
So.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me just tell y'all that somebody, Instagram said that some hoes want a sampler.
Some hoes want a what?
Sampler. Sampler platter.
A different.
But
different.
All at the same time?
Hey, one thing about that, I'm going to tell you, niggas from Atlanta, different breed, though. I bet every girl that been ran through, I bet them the same one when they check their pocketbook after they got ran through.
They money gone.
Like, they pay for that. They pay for it, though, bro. I'm telling you, that's
straight
from Atlanta, so I mean.
Hey, y'all are a different breed, though.
I'm telling you,
bro.
I bet if they listening and you remember when that shit happened to you and you said and you, whatever happened, I bet your goddamn pocketbook when you goddamn through. You paying for that dick. Cause that's the first thing happened.
Gotta get you
well,
before you get me, right?
Yeah.
Me and my homegirl were talking the other day, and like she could remember when a dude stole her homegirl Air Max. Like Atlanta niggas just I'll be on some stupid shit.
I swear to God, bro.
And they might not even need it.
I know them niggas. I know all them niggas.
So, right. So it's y'all niggas' fault that all these motherfucking Atlanta women so goddamn hard.
Probably, bro.
Yeah. Cause y'all.
But they like, you sign up for 3, 4, 5 dicks. You don't need no money. You finna pay for this dick. You think you finna come up and go to Six Flags? 5 niggas bounce up in you. You gonna have to pay for that.
Hey, man, I have heard the strangest stories about how these dudes were straight wrong. Now, they be talking about women. Oh, women be doing it. Man, it's some dudes out here is way worse off than women. Cause I have heard the story. I be like, what? That's part of the price that you pay when you kind of like dealing with people who either done gave you them red flags and you ignored them. Or dealing with people you just don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, women will take a loss like that. If $40 get rid of a nigga going to your purse, getting however much money it is to get rid of him, if it's less than, like, $200, let him go. Because, if you let that shit go and act like it ain't him, you going to lose more than that. Mm. So, it's like, you know what? I'm just glad he showed me. Bye.
I don't see it. I don't see it now.
What you mean? The nigga don't answer the phone no more.
I just steal that pocketbook. I don't know.
But I don't
see
it.
I can count on two hands.
I fuck up at. I be giving money trying to help out. I need to be stealing the money. God damn it.
Got it wrong.
Damn,
you doing wrong now.
Again.
You got it wrong.
God damn it. I need to steal money.
Right.
Then y'all, them motherfuckers be all in love with me and shit. Yeah. I need to steal money. Okay, thank you, Donnie.
No, I mean, that's just what
we need some people to chime in. All the women who, how many women have ever got shit stolen out of their pocketbook?
I know plenty of women that, I'm like, I'm one of these kind of people. And I ain't saying that I'm smarter than the average bear or no shit like that. But, like, I don't be too comfortable. And
why women be having sex with niggas they can't trust their pocketbook around?
Yeah, like I couldn't.
Dickmatized, maybe.
Yeah.
I don't damn.
Well, that's like a nigga having sex with, this shit happens.
There ain't no difference than a nigga having sex with a woman that gonna go in their wallet. So it's like.
Yeah, I know nigga when they deal with shit, how they got them leave shit in the car.
It gets weird, but and I'm gonna be honest with you, and that's why I always like my energy some kind of way attract men that want to help. It don't attract men that
You got a law of attraction.
Yeah, like
you give out, like you give out what you.
Yeah,
what
you don't. Want to receive, I don't attract. Right? Like I don't really attract the dude that'll go in your pocket. Right. Like, I ain't attracted to that nigga. I hope I don't never attract
the raw
nobody like that. And yeah, like
they fuck you, then fuck you.
Right, literally. Double whammy. Nigga hit you with the double whammy.
Right.
You be like, what? That's so when true. I be hearing stories like that, yeah, my homegirl would tell me about one time a dude screwed a friend and screwed her so good she just went on and fell asleep. That nigga ran off with a damn Air Max and some other shit. And I was like, what?
That's cold blood.
I couldn't imagine sleeping with a nigga that I can't trust around my goddamn shoes. What?
He had another problem. He had problems. He's gonna get some Air Max from. For
like, bro, yeah. Like.
Man.
They was used, man, but she only had them a day or two. Like they were fresh. Go
scrub them up.
I got a color blue two hole with one blender.
I know, right? Petty thief.
Right.
Nigga, that boy. Petty thief. That
real. It's some shit need to be on TV.
Right, for real. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, when you grow up around, I think we got all different kind of men in our family and our, that
was,
I mean,
we got good examples
us.
And we got.
Yeah, good examples and like fucked up examples.
You know
feel
what I'm saying?
What I'm saying? As a matter of fact.
Up.
The only time I ever took a loss was one of his friends, and I wasn't even having sex with him.
Oh, yeah, I knew that.
I wasn't
rocked,
even sleeping with him.
Yeah. Yeah, he rocked.
Like, that shit was crazy. I wasn't even sleeping with him. I'm like, what the fuck? What?
Right.
The fuck is wrong with this cat? Like, this nigga crazy.
Wrong. Mm.
But you know what I'm saying? He a preacher now.
He saved.
They get your shit back.
I ain't gay. Hey, home went, no, dead ass home went to rehab and called me one day and was like, man, I'm so sorry. You know, I really do apologize for taking, you know, whatever I took from you. I'm going to start paying you back. And I was like, all right.
Yeah.
I said, hit me up when you're ready, you know. Next time nigga hit me up, he was talking about coming to his church. I said, nigga, three years ago, you just called me and told me, because my number been the same forever. I said, you told me you were going to start paying me. What happened to that?
Right. He spoke out of time.
Yeah, like, and that's crazy. Any man that ever took money, as a matter of fact, he the first one, and there was another one that I wasn't even sleeping with.
Who?
Derek Duffy.
A whole lot.
Lame ass.
Yeah, you call a nigga name?
Hell yeah, huh?
Who the hell is that?
Nah, that ain't a legend. Were fucked. That nigga took my goddamn money on some business shit.
He get his whole name called.
Hell yeah. He took my money on some slime ball business shit.
Right.
But I wasn't even sleeping with him.
Mm.
So, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's crazy.
Part of the story, you can get robbed by any goddamn body.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
But I don't fuck with home walking or running.
Whoever that is,
leaving
the she don't fuck with
going or coming. Yeah, like I don't, like for real.
Right.
I don't have no problem with it. That nigga know what's going on.
Ooh.
It ain't no pressure.
It has to be a low down motherfucker to have sex with you and steal money from you.
Man, no. Hey man.
Hey bro. I don't see. I can't even speak. I don't see it happen.
I'm just saying.
Times.
I ain't saying it ain't happening. I'm just saying how low down do you have to be?
That's
like,
low down as hell.
How? What do your mindset have to be that you just have sex with somebody then right after you have sex with them, steal money from them? I mean,
But my mind don't even work like that. I wouldn't even like. Even because
my mind don't work like that.
You know, they say women be doing that too.
Women do it.
Said
the brick roll
is out.
What? Say word.
Well, shout out, Kim Folk. She said, yeah.
Okay, shout out.
With the slime ass.
Right, with the slime ball ass, nigga. Nah, but for real, like you have examples of the good, you know, good people, and you have examples of ones you got to watch.
Mm-hmm.
The thing about it is, I just hope I don't never track a nigga want to sleep with me and then steal from me, because, boy, I don't know what that's called, but I don't think I want none.
It's me either. Up. I don't want to track the bitch that's going to steal from me either, because I'm willing to give.
That's
like,
a different level
like, if you willing to give, like, why you got to steal it from me?
That's,
you know,
that's a different
well,
level of
it's kind of like this. Because I don't like thieves, period. Once I figure out that's what you are, I don't care if you family. I don't care who you are. Like, I can't.
I can't fuck with you.
No. Definitely ain't finna try to sleep with the enemy on purpose.
Right. Yeah. I don't
get it. It's trick out here. All I tell you, women, you don't know that nigga that good. You better hide your shit. Don't get digmatized and
right.
fall asleep.
Fall asleep. You're going to be mad.
Eyes wide open.
Boy, I got a partner who used to sneak out the house on women and everything. Wake up, nigga
what?
Gone, money gone,
oh, wow.
Purse, whole purse might be, like anything.
Ooh.
It used to be a meme that was floating around that a little boy was waking his mama like, "Mom, you know the man who spent the night last night? He got our TV and our games." I couldn't imagine taking my kids to no crazy
shit
like
that,
that.
Right?
They wake up, see a nigga unhooking their game and their TV, and they got to keep acting sleep because they don't want no smoke. Jeez. As soon as he leave, you got to go in there and wake your mom. That's got to be embarrassing.
That shit that rough.
Exactly. Like, your kids gonna be looking at you crazy, but you'll be surprised. It's a lot of them that do that.
Yeah.
Gotta be careful with it. You gotta, like, for real, I don't want none. they say them kind of men have the best sex ever.
Mm.
I don't want none.
They call that hobo sex.
I'm all right. Right.
Hobo.
Hobo sex. They be hobosexuals.
Oh, they be
okay.
Hobosexual. That
yeah.
They need a lot of steak.
Strong backs.
So they fuck for a place to
they
stay.
They fucking the
yeah.
Kiyachi.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Damn, I ain't never been homeless. That's my fault. Damn, I'm learning what my issues are.
Right.
I ain't never been homeless.
Right.
Okay.
That was going on.
Okay.
Lab, you got to get some flaws. You
I got to get a few. I got to get some. Motherfuckers seem to be attracted to niggas with flaws. Like, they'll go over and beyond for a nigga with a flaw. But a nigga with some good got a good shit going on a little bit.
You can't act like you got good
they
sense.
They're going to run over your ass.
They're going to take advantage
time.
Of you. Like you
yeah.
got good sense?
Yeah, I'm learning that. Like
you
act got
you.
Good sense.
Yeah.
They're going to run over you like a motherfucker. But nigga who ain't got none.
But guess what? But it's the same way with women. It's the same
them.
Way with women. Our playing field is the same.
I
niggas do not men do not like women with good sense.
I
like
think,
if you see
well,
like
women, the crazy women got the best sex. See, most niggas ain't out there looking for no.
Nah, I don't know. I don't know about that. I don't know if it's just.
You ain't never had crazy woman sex?
Yeah, I was married to a motherfucker of crazy. Didn't know she was crazy until we got to 15 years into the program.
Shout out to the niggas that know about that crazy woman.
Shit, that shit was a mask all goddamn day. Cold blooded ass motherfucker.
Ain't that crazy though?
Cold blooded.
But you know them kind of those kind of people make it hard for you to even
for the genuine people.
Yeah, for you to even accept genuine people.
Yeah,
and
I don't fuck with motherfuckers like that. I always suspect the bullshit. I always suspect the unhand shit.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
and
because
that'd be
that's
bad.
Through
that
experience.
To good people though. Like good people get turned.
I
to
always expect the bullshit. Like I'll be looking for that man. Shit, and then when it come, I'll be like, aha.
Daddy.
Uh-oh, who is that?
Get out of my business.
Who is that, Rico? Oh, they on Instagram. Mm-hmm. Oh, that cool.
Shut up, cool.
Right. He definitely knows.
About it, I damn sure know what crazy sex is.
Jesus Christ. The thing about it is, I think women with good sex have good sex too. It's just that.
Yeah, I'm sure. I guess.
It's something about it, but women with good sense don't get no fair chance. Like
so
women
we all
that ain't
the same,
got no good
we
sense.
On the same keel with that shit.
That's what I'm saying. It's the same playing field, the same way it is for women and for men it is
yeah.
for women.
That's why you got to, if you're trying to have a real relationship, you got to base it on something more than sex. Like, sex gonna always be a component in it.
Yeah.
But when you look at something real, you gotta base it on something like that, because you base it on that, you gonna pick the wrong motherfucker
every time. Now, I say that all the time,
too.
If you
base it on that, you still gonna pick the wrong motherfucker. Yeah. You still gonna pick the wrong motherfucker.
Well, it's a crapshoot. I was finna say, I was just about to say that.
About shit. Yeah.
Well, see, this is the thing right here. See, I put up a post the other day on Instagram talking about them 2 week relationships.
Mm.
Them motherfuckers be fun. They do. Yeah. They be real fun. The
Your old face is like, they be real fun. Like, woo.
Playing 2 weeks.
Until you get them first set of crazy texts.
Right. Seriously, it don't take you but 2 weeks for, like,
You think it only take 2 weeks?
Man, the shit. Did that in time. But these niggas show crazy quick.
Hey, I got a
quick.
Because y'all like crazy, so we going
to. Oh, no, I don't like crazy.
I got
a. That's why I can seriously ignore the hell out of them. I'd be like, you know what? I ain't even finna get that shit no more energy. I ain't even finna answer. I ain't even finna, like, no.
I advise everybody at this stage, when you get them first red flags, move on.
Them can't deal with.
Before you get entangled up, you know, into some bullshit.
Them can't deal with.
Yeah, you can't deal with. Yeah, you see a red flag, get the hell on.
But see, this is the thing right here. You know? Red flags, some red flags are doable. Some of them are not. The I can't deal with is like, you know that ain't really part of what you're trying to do.
Mm-hmm.
If they show that shit, please go on about your business, because y'all ain't going to do nothing but waste each other's time.
Right.
And I'm okay. But see, the problem with me is I'm okay with wasting the nigga time. Like, and I'm okay with a dude wasting mine to a certain extent.
Right.
Well, dating is dating.
That's what I'm saying.
Look, I mean, when you dating, you dating. See, people don't understand. Dating is you meet multiple people and you going out. You testing the water. That don't mean you fucking everybody. You just... We going
Definitely
out, we enjoying each other's company.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if we can go any further, get to the point. That's dating. Dating is cool. I think all single people.
How long you got to wait till you fuck?
It depends.
It depends on how you feel.
If you fuck
the
on the first night, that's just grown. I mean, you'd be surprised the people in relationships that done met and sparks fly first night. You know, I mean, it depends. I don't think that should be the basis of not being in relationships about just because you had sex quick. I mean, you could wait for, say, 6 months.
I'm just asking, in general. Like,
I don't think you should base that on how quick I...
Because
quick
usually the sex. Crazy show up after the sex happens.
You think so?
Sometimes. Most of the times.
Yeah, because a person will pretend to
be... Yeah, that's
where
the irrational shit go to.
Yeah, a person will pretend to be somebody else until they actually have sex. You know what? I can agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
I can agree with that, but... I just kind of think that sometimes people put that shit on a back burner up until after they have sex. Because they be done showed you certain stuff,
and then
you still be like, well, I mean, I like them enough to sleep with them type shit. And, you know, like, I honestly feel like I think they still ignore certain stuff just to give a person a chance. But I'm like,
shit,
I don't know.
You
but
damn right there. No, I...
You got me.
Man, it was so many goddamn red flags before when I got married. I should have been left that shit.
Yeah. Well, you didn't, but now
shit.
You can
but you
look.
Know why you stayed in there? Love.
Your
kids. See,
yeah,
maybe a
oh,
lot.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
You be like,
definitely.
Man.
Nah, I ain't gonna lie. I was in love with that motherfucker.
Yeah,
hell yeah.
How many children y'all got?
Three.
How many girls?
One.
Just one girl?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
One girl and two boys. Is it what, boy, girl, boy? Or?
Mm-hmm. Boy, girl, boy, yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
But yeah, like a lot of times you will. It's kind of like this. You can look back at it now and know that there were red flags.
Man, it was so many of them. I was like, I know love blind motherfucker. It was so many red flags. I was like, that ain't shit. Yeah. I can deal with that. You know what I'm saying?
You probably could.
Yeah, it was just certain shit, but it was a lot of other shit that I probably shouldn't have let slide that I did let slide.
But you think you did it out of the sake of love?
I want to say the first 15, 16, 17, yeah, I was definitely in love. Like, I was in love with that motherfucker. Like, it wasn't, no, she could do no wrong. Mm. Like, I wanted to make heaven open.
See,
for
that's the kind of, I want a nigga to love me like that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it was nothing,
a lot of pressure coming
with that. It was nothing that
Is
she
it?
Should, that
what
she
kind
should
of pressure
want.
Come with, love?
No,
what kind of
pressure
well,
I ain't going to say, that? I ain't going to say, it's good pressure, though.
Like, I mean, but if you love that person genuinely,
you should want them to,
you should want them to be happy. You should want to make sure they don't want for anything. And that's where I was. That's where I was at. I was like, ain't no reason. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no reason why this motherfucker should have to want or you know what I'm saying, or be upset about
anything. So what made that turn to something totally different, to the total opposite?
Well, what happens is little things start happening, then you start noticing stuff like for me.
You start questioning stuff.
You start questioning stuff. Mm-hmm. See, I wasn't questioning anything. I questioned nothing. She say she gonna do that, she doing it. You know what I'm saying? It was no questions for me. But then when little red flags, like you say, God starts showing you stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, this little
showing
stuff.
You stuff you ain't looking for.
Right, you ain't looking for. Yeah. Like, all right, then this nigga been married for 19 years. It's time to start showing him little stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because it was like little things that would show up, and I'd be like, you know, because you don't want to accuse somebody of something you don't know for sure. Yeah. That's where I was at first. So I never asked any questions about it because I wasn't sure. Whereas I should have probably asked, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? I probably should say, hey, what's up with this? Or why that? Or, you know, what the fuck you doing with this? You know what I'm saying? But I never did that. So you get what I'm saying? So a little stuff started showing up, and I started thinking, like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying?
Let me ask you this. When that was going on, do you think she probably felt like you knew, but you was cool with it?
No, I think she thought I was stupid.
Oh, she put you on, okay.
See, a lot of times women think that they got you pussymatized, and they think that you see certain things and that you're not stupid enough to put two together. I'm going to give you a good example. That's how I know she thought I was stupid. She talked to a friend of hers on the phone one day, and they had went on a girls trip and all this other shit. So she, like, I'm in the next room. She in our, I think I was in the room with my son or something. And she was like, oh, they was arguing. The girl was like, oh, she had on speak. She said, oh, you keep fucking with me, I'm going to tell Lee everything you did while you was out of town. And instead of her saying, well, go on, tell him, because ain't shit to say, she said, well, he ain't going to believe you. So I'm like, what the fuck? Like, he ain't going to believe you. Like, he too stupid
to believe you.
What you saying. So that shit like, oh. So.
But what kind of partners you got to even threaten some shit like that?
Well, they was arguing and shit. So I don't know what they was fucking arguing about, but. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. But that's what I'm saying. Like,
so
first of all,
I ain't this shit.
I ain't this shit. Like, here, nigga, talk to him. Here you go. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Talk to him. What the fuck? Like, if it was me, a motherfucker said, that's all shit, nigga. You ain't saying shit. Huh. Hear the phone. Talk to him. Tell him what you
but
got to tell
her.
And that made you feel
the
way. That made you feel the way.
Even threaten that, though. Like,
I don't know what
you
they
was
on.
With it. That's
what,
see, that's what I'm saying, but you
was
with all of that up until I pissed you off.
And that's generally how it goes.
Like
the friends be up with
hell
the shit.
Yeah.
Friends be hiding shit, and you know,
you
call them up and be like, what's wrong?
They know what the body's
here. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, and this happened before. It's happened before where they were arguing about some shit, and some shit was saying, I kind of just ignored it, or I didn't, you know.
Just two women arguing.
Yeah, you know,
is she still a friend? I know you don't probably not
know
now.
I don't
but,
know really anything about her friendship or anything since. Let me tell you, when
no,
I got
I'm saying,
divorced,
did she remain friends with her?
I don't know. I don't know, because after all that, and then I found out the other stuff, it was kind of a succession of things.
Okay.
I started preparing myself to leave.
Yeah.
Because it's a lot of shit I can put up with as a person. As a mate, I'm gonna do everything I can for you as my mate.
Yeah.
I make sure everything, like, you know, motherfuckers trip when you say, I'm not saying that I'm gonna be obsessed with you, but you're gonna be my world. We're gonna be what it is. We're just gonna be me and you against the world.
Against, right.
And whatever the fuck else come in between that shit, nothing comes between that as far as I'm concerned.
Mm-hmm. So y'all on that Will and Jada shit.
Well, no,
y'all
because
life
that
partners.
Motherfucker, no, that motherfucker cheat. Yeah. There ain't no, that's it. Because I feel like if you bold enough to cheat on me, all the shit I'm doing to make sure we good, you bold enough to cheat on me with another motherfucker and you ain't got shit to worry about, no bills to pay, no nothing, and you still fucking cheat on me, you don't respect me. Mm-hmm. That's how I feel. Because I'm making sure I'm working 2-3 jobs, make sure we good, bills paid, everything good. And you still want to go and cheat on me with another motherfucker that ain't doing shit, or a motherfucker that you feel like you attracted to, or that's your type. And fuck you and him. Go be with him. Let him do what the fuck.
Let him pick up the slack.
Let him pick up the slack. Because why I need to be here, you more happy with him because you want to put him over me. So,
I know
the world
that.
Is, my friend let me know this, what I won't do, another nigga will. So, I'm good with that. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I know that that's how it goes.
Hold. Wait a minute.
My friend tell me all the time that. These niggas don't realize that what one nigga don't do, another nigga will. So
I agree.
And then I feel like if she felt like that other nigga would do that, let her have.
Most of the time, that ain't even how it go, though.
Hey.
In a perfect world, it would go like that.
I had to learn from my friend.
But you realize that nigga
she
you thought
was going
to do shit, he in
So
the,
I
he
had to
trick.
Listen to what she says as a woman.
Man, you don't.
And
let me
I feel like my ex-wife felt that way. Like, she may have not said it to me,
she felt like she could move on.
Yeah, you get what I'm saying? Like, she felt like
she felt like she was the prize.
Right, exactly.
And that's perfectly okay, because that's cool that you think that, but the reason you can feel like that is because of the way I treat you.
Exactly.
Like,
she didn't realize that.
That's the reason why you could feel like you the prize, because I treat you like that. Mm. So if you're expecting that for somebody else, that's gonna be your loss. My thing is this right here. I ain't letting go for sure, I don't know. I don't give a damn. That don't make sense in no kind of way.
But she wasn't,
Regardless, I think somebody else would do it.
She wasn't smart to think that way. You get what I'm saying? Like,
well, you know what it was? Y'all was so young, and she felt like y'all had been together so long.
But at that point, it's too late to think about what was.
Mm-hmm.
To me, at that point, the time to think about that shit when we was 21, 23, mm-hmm. just getting out of college.
I know.
That's when your point is.
She probably in her wildest mind never thought you would leave.
Right, but at that point, that's when you're supposed to say to yourself, as college, when we get out of college, we got two kids, mm-hmm. and you feel like, well, shit, we've been together too long. I done got my degree, he done got his degree, let's go on our separate ways. Not when we 40, or, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. We done been 21, 20 years into this shit. It's too late now.
Yeah.
To me, it's too late to live your high school dreams and college dreams.
But the way some women mentality is set up, like with me, I'm okay with getting older and being seasoned, because I appreciate all the shit I done learned.
Exactly.
Whereas some women don't really appreciate that though. They feel like they done missed out on something. I can't really feel like I done missed out on anything, because I don't think I did. Like I did in everything that I wanted to do. But a lot of times when a woman marries early, she feels like she has missed out on a lot. Not understanding that her walk ain't another person's walk.
Right.
So because you got married early, really, you should be kind of grateful to me that you really took, you know what I'm saying, that was your lane.
Yeah. You got married early. We both went to college. You know what I'm saying? We both did everything we were supposed to do as far as that was concerned.
Yeah.
And you had a partner that, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this motherfucker didn't keep jobs very long, but she had a degree, so she could go from job to job. But it was just like, it would be a year or so without working, but we still good, because I work. Okay, you ain't got no job, whatever. I'm gonna always take your side. I don't give a fuck who it was.
Yeah.
This me and you, right? So you ain't got no job, cool. I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. But she just never kept a job for very long. You get what? I don't know what the deal was, but she never kept a job for very long. But I always tried to make sure we was good by working two or three jobs.
I could probably tell you why she couldn't keep the job very long, but that's a whole nother show.
Yeah, that's a whole nother show. Yeah. But she couldn't keep the job very long, but it was still cool, because we in this together. I'm not gonna look at you and be like, well, where your money at?
You get what I'm saying? You know that was a red flag too.
Oh yeah. Now I know. But see, I didn't know then. You get what I'm saying? Like, if a motherfucker come on me and say, such and such treat me bad, well, fuck that shit, yo. He treat you bad, go back to work, do whatever you, and then if he treat you bad again, then you ain't got to worry about that. So it was always somebody else's fault.
Right.
It never was her fault, but then you come to find out, well, damn, you got a bad attitude at work. You get what I'm saying? Like, motherfucker don't fuck with you because your attitude nasty.
Yeah, like
nasty.
Chris Rock mama. My husband got two goddamn jobs.
Right,
exactly. Yeah. So, you know, it's just a succession of things after I sat back and thought about, like, damn, I put up with a lot of shit, you know what I'm saying, to try to make this motherfucker try to make us happy. I'm not saying just her, but us as a collective.
Well, happy life, a life of kids.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Us as a collective happy. And I felt like once that old other shit happened, it was like a betrayal to me. Like, you know what? You ain't worth, you know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got the time to, you ain't taking into consideration the shit that goes on with us as a group, that you want to let this other motherfucker slide in, or other plural motherfucker slide in. And, you know, he getting husband privileges without the motherfucking husband
responsibilities, right?
Because if you fucking this motherfucking everything, he getting the prize without any other motherfucking effort to get to the prize,
right?
You get what I'm saying?
But
so,
you know, the average person that deal with a person with somebody, when that somebody find out or lead them, the other person just don't even be wanting them.
Mm.
You feel what I'm saying? You know how people be like, the position opened up, but the position don't really open up, because the person that's with, like, say for instance, if you was married, say for instance you married and you cheat with somebody and you tell them that you married and they still be all right with it.
But time you say you ain't married no more.
But time you be like, yeah, I'm leaving my wife. My wife and
you holler,
and
for
she like,
what?
Yeah, she like the fuck for. Why for you what? Doing that? Why is we leaving her? Like I like this setup.
Say we're a big family.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So it's kind of like that's usually how it happens, but a lot of time women be naive, they don't really know that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you done destroyed your family.
Right.
And then they ain't finna, none of them niggas ain't finna be around. Because for one, they ain't finna, they not finna hold the responsibility of all this shit you got.
They really want to shake your hood for hand.
Right. Right. They want to give your hood a hug. Like, you tripping. Like, you said you let him find out what?
Right.
Like, you tripping.
Yeah. You need to pass that shit up right now.
Right. For real.
Right now, pass that shit up.
Right. For real.
Well, I can't be with you like that.
For real, because people who get in them situations that know what's going on, like, they like the situation. It's right. Like, I don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, is this going to be what we got going on? That's what I want it to be.
Right. Right.
But you'll be surprised. But I think a lot of time women do go through them identity crisis when they get married young and just feel like they missing out on stuff.
We was young. And we did get, you know what I'm saying? We had kids. We had a lot of responsibilities.
I don't think you use that for an excuse to disrespect somebody, man. And
I say you can't, but yeah. I mean.
Yeah, I definitely don't think you should be. That ain't no excuse.
I feel like if you was a hoe in the beginning, you should just, hey. You know I got whole tendencies, right?
Right.
You may not want to marry me with my whole tendencies. You may want to.
You wouldn't have heard him.
I would.
That would have sounded like shit. That would have sounded like,
baby. And look, she
might
have told you that shit, and you were like,
right.
She might have said it on the side. I was
right.
Like,
and you was like, no,
it sounded
baby.
Like this. Wah, wah, wah,
I can,
wah,
I can help you, baby. Look, I can help you. Let me help you through that.
I was trying to save a hoe on that.
Right.
Let me go and take care of you, put you under my wing.
Because sometimes people do tell you exactly what the hell they are and who they are. I promise you. That's why it go back. Like, with me personally, when it come to dating, I listen and I will ghost them off quick.
Right.
And I know I got to do better with that because that I think that people should know why you don't want them or why you ain't
interested
or whatever. Because I met a dude.
If I'm dating Donna and she just leave me and I think I'm doing everything right, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I do. I should probably give an explanation.
No, man. I can't. It's certain things that you do that I can't. And she tell me what those things are. You get what I'm saying? Then I won't be bitter. Like, what I'm saying? Like,
I think that will help people better themselves or try to be better for the next person.
But see, that's what I'm saying. Like, but the next person might not require that. That's one reason why I don't even want because I don't want them
to compare
exactly. Like, I got, like, seriously, I don't want that. I just rather disappear, like, because, and
but
shit.
Disappearing ain't good, though. It's like.
It ain't, I don't know. Because
he made me
know.
Thinking, oh, we good. We finna build on this shit. And then all of a sudden, you don't answer the phone. You don't call him back. You don't text.
That ghosting, boy.
That ghost.
Nigga was doing that shit before they knew they called, before it had a name.
You get what I'm saying?
It's just kind of like this right here. That I think that a lot of times people be knowing. Now, I can't put that on it. But a lot of times, like, people know, like, this, because, like, so I got people that always feel like they need to match me up with somebody. And I'm like, you don't really need to do that because, like, I'm okay. And then they still do it. And then I'm like.
Do they hit you with anybody that's worth dating?
Not to me, because, like, this one dude, his homeboy had introduced me to him. And you know how a person just sound like they, like, just, I don't know. It was
too good to be true or something?
Nah, hell nah. It wasn't too good
to be true. Too bad to be true? God damn.
It wasn't too bad to be true. Nick just wasn't for me. Like,
oh, okay.
And I told him home, but I was like, bro, why would you even think I like him? Like, do you even know this man's situation? He was like, man, he worked. He got this going on, that going on. He trying to put him off on you. Yeah, but I'm like. Man, it gonna take a little more than that. Like, home don't even sound stable. He was like, what you mean? I was like, bro,
he sound like a hobo. That's what I mean.
Like, he don't have no kids. Like, he got good qualities, but from what I could get from the conversation, he gonna get on my nerve.
And he might be a serial killer.
Yeah, like he's yeah.
Well, I mean, how would he got what was the conversation that made you okay? Just okay.
What was the first red flag?
What was the first thing that made you say this nigga gonna get on my nerve?
Like, I was talking to him, I'm like, okay, so he asked me, like, something about what were some of the things that I like to do or something like that. And I was like, I mean, I'm kind of open, but I don't really care about nothing. I try almost anything once. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't care, but it ain't nothing that I like to really do in particular.
Mm-hmm.
He said, oh, okay. He was like, well, let me tell you, he don't even give me a chance to ask him what some of the things, because I don't really ask a whole lot of questions. I wasn't going to ask him that. Right. And I think when he started off with, yeah, because you know what I'm saying? Like, let me tell you what, I like women. I like to do this for my woman. I like to do that for my woman. And I'm like, first of all, he took the whole question that he asked me and made it into some bullshit.
He won't tell you what he like to goddamn do.
Wait, no. See, the question was what she liked to do. He telling her what he liked to do for her. He ain't telling her what he likes to do. Like, I like football. I like to watch
right.
football.
Right.
I like to go to the museum. Okay. He's
telling
her what he's trying to impress her on upon.
About stuff that he has done for other women.
Right.
And I'm like.
Okay.
Yeah, like, I was like, what? I was like, okay, so he gonna have a comprehension problem because I can see now that
he don't know how to answer questions.
He don't know how to answer questions right. And I ain't even asked him, keeping in mind, I didn't ask him a question. He asked me a question, and I guess because I didn't ask him back, he's just gonna throw that shit out there. Like, no.
I think.
Hell no, like.
I think when we meet y'all women in Atlanta, y'all ID should say where y'all from. So, like, it'd be like, Decatur Ho. Westside Ho. So, we know how to come at you. And
no.
Like, that ain't your ID, and it'd be
so
like,
you
Westside Ho. Like, oh, okay.
So, you don't think.
Let me come at you different. Let me not say nothing. Let me
no,
not ask you no questions.
No, it's not that. Let me tell you, I don't mind. I don't mind answering questions.
Well, let me tell you, though, he was trying to impress upon you that he's a good dude. So
but see,
instead of you taking it as
that,
your
that.
Ass was like, man, this nigga right here better get on my damn nerve.
Yeah,
nerd.
Because
like,
of the simple fact, let me tell you something. It don't take that for me. It don't take.
But he don't know that. He getting to know that
but
you.
The whole point of the matter is he'll know from now on, like, what the fuck happened. That's what I'm saying. Like, he can't come. Like, I understand that he don't know me. Like, I get that. But at the same time, I know that shit he did just then would get on my fucking nerves because that ain't gonna be the only time he gonna do that.
How you know though? He just seen you.
I could tell. I could tell that's a part of his character. And so
always ask a question wrong.
Right, not so much as ask a question, but keep in mind I didn't ask him no question.
But that's how you get a. That's how.
But he don't even know if I was gonna ask him a question. He didn't even give me a chance.
Okay. You like a slow conversation.
No, listen. If you
don't like a nigga rush to the conversation.
You don't like a rush to the conversation. You want that nigga to take his time.
Nigga, slow down through the conversation. You taking me too
fast.
This
ain't going nowhere. Just slow down. Damn.
I'm just saying, like. And then I hit it. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna say this and then we're gonna go on to end the show. So then one time he called and he has all this noise in the background. So I'm just really thinking to myself, why would you call somebody? Why not just text them and be, you know, ask them what are they doing or how you doing, how your day going? You call me with all this noise in the background. I'm like, what the fuck? So I'm like, hello, can you hear me? Yeah, like you hollering in the phone. Yeah, hold on. I'm in the studio. So that's what I'm saying. Like, dude, you 45. Like, why in the hell are you calling
you
me from the No. But
you better put out his new EP.
Let me tell you, that's right. No. That was the That was the first one. When he did that second thing, I was like, he ain't a nigga I can deal with. So he hollering all this. I hung up and I texted him. I said, why would you call me with all that noise going on? You okay? Somebody kidnap you? You in danger? Like, what the fuck? He was like, he steps out of the studio. But let me just tell y'all how it sounds like pots and pans banging. It don't necessarily sound like the kind of studio I'm used to. So he steps away from it, calls me back, and he's like, no, we working. You know, I'm doing this. It was something he was saying he was doing. So I was like, okay. I said, well, don't call me with all that shit going on. Like, you know, you could have just texted me. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't call me.
That was a flex move, man.
So he was like, dang.
Damn, you don't even let nigga flex.
No, I don't need all that. So he was like.
You don't even let nigga flex.
He was like, dang. So he was like, dang, I'm sorry, love. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know, you know what I'm saying, I was like, you couldn't hear anything I was saying. So you got to know that that's annoying. Like, you got to. So since you don't know, I'm just letting you know that's annoying. Don't call me with all that going on. I was like, you know, I'm at the house. I'm cooling. I'm chilling. So he was like, okay. But I knew after that second go round when he did all that shit with that question, I was like, nah.
So, fellas, the moral of the story?
Like,
no. Don't be bullshitting at the beginning. Don't be fucking around with
not with me because I'm too transparent. Like,
you live and you learn, man. Like,
yeah, like certain stuff ain't gonna flout me. If you 45, like, I ain't being funny, but calling somebody
age discriminate.
I'm not. I'm saying
I'm 45 and he had that first record yet.
Oh no, I ain't even talking about that because I don't even know what kind of music he do. He could.
Oh, okay.
I don't even know what kind of music you do. I don't care about that.
He do smooth jazz.
But the whole point of the matter is, if you 45, just certain etiquette you should have. Like, don't be calling people with all that noise in the background. And then, yeah, that's my homeboy. What? At 45? Mm. No.
Jesus Christ.
No. And then gonna tell me, oh. One more thing.
One more thing.
This man says to me, he was like, what, you got an Android or app or iPhone? So I was like, I got an iPhone. He was like, I had an iPhone, man. I cracked my screen, so I'm waiting on them to send me another phone. I don't give a damn what kind of phone he got. I never, certain stuff don't matter to me. So I was like, oh, okay. Like, 3 days, 4 days later, I said something. Oh, I said, I'm going to call you right back. Did somebody FaceTiming me? This man got heated. I hung up, but I did text him back. It was like, I'm off the phone. You can hit me up, you know what I'm saying, if you want to call me back. This man was like, so you mean to tell me you'll get off the phone with me because somebody FaceTiming you? I can't wait till I get my iPhone back.
You probably put that nigga on block.
I was like, this nigga weird. I was like, what? I was like, yeah,
you throwing up in his face, his damn phone.
His
fucked
phone
up.
Yeah, but keep in mind, he asked
so
me
you trying
about
to flex
my
on
phone.
Him now. You,
right.
You let him flex at the studio, but
I'm
you flexing
you,
with your iPhone FaceTime.
It don't take for 2 weeks. All of this happened in the span of 2 weeks. So that's why I'm like, yeah, bro, it's tripping. He got to get ghosted. Like,
so you flexing on him, but you wouldn't let him flex on you. So it's a double standard. Like, he couldn't studio flex you, and you iPhone flexing him.
Like, I wasn't iPhone flexing him.
Yeah,
I didn't
was.
Even know he
all
got.
All you had to do was say,
how you get
somebody
offended?
Called me, let me get back to you. You ain't have to be like, oh, let somebody is FaceTiming me.
Well, that's
let
what
me
they was
go
doing.
And answer the other FaceTime
even
line. You don't have FaceTime, so I can't FaceTime.
If you had
no.
FaceTime,
if
you
had
FaceTime.
No.
I'll be FaceTiming you. But you, that's what he heard.
Well, he's stupid. That go again. Why would I want to deal with somebody like that?
And you really got to find somebody that y'all communicate on the same level too. Like, you know, everybody talking about communication the key, but it ain't communication the
comprehension. Yeah, like that's what I'm saying.
He
like
comprehended
he,
that your ass was trying to flex on him with the FaceTime.
He clearly showed me that his comprehension skills ain't up to par. That's what I'm saying. So it only take 2 weeks. It only take 2 weeks for
that's
a person to
take.
Show you that
two
shit.
Weeks.
So you be like, no. Like, I'm one of them kind of people because I be prepared not to speak to motherfuckers ever. It don't, you know what I'm saying? So I'm one of them kind of people where I could be like, no. And just go on about my business. And then they go back to likes on Instagram. Like, they'll find my Instagram or some, or... And then it just go back to likes on Instagram. Like, I don't, like it'd be easier that way. If I ghost them, and then they just go back to social media and just be, like stuff and shit like that. Like, maybe hit my DM and be like, boy, you something else. I'd be like, yeah.
You fine.
Like, seriously. Like, oh, okay, yeah. And the end. But however, yeah, 5 years, y'all.
5 years.
5 years in.
Yes.
And count.
And count. So we look forward to doing some. What's up? Let's go. Let's get it.
Next week, we're going to have a segment called Remember the Time.
Remember the Time.
Yeah. Okay,
we're going to do it today, but we just didn't get it in.
Yeah.
But those not going to do a second.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're going to do it next week.
Yep. Why y'all didn't get it in?
You were talking about all that old bullshit.
Yeah, we ain't wanna
I was talking about it.
We won't cut you off.
I can't talk by myself.
We ain't want to be rude.
We ain't want to be rude.
Y'all be on some bullshit.
We want you to get that off your chest.
Yeah.
What? I didn't even have nothing to get off my chest.
We're going to do it next week, though.
Yeah, we're going to do it next week.
Y'all already got the songs?
Yeah, we're going to have new songs.
Yeah,
we're going to
have new songs. We had five this week. We're going to add more to it.
Yeah.
How long is it going to be?
I don't know.
We're going to spin and talk.
Since we own the radio, we can take as long as we want down.
So why we couldn't do it today?
Because we finna end the show.
The show finna be over. We can do one, though. Let's do one. Which one you got?
Okay, which one you want to do?
Let's do Jodeci, Forever My Name.
Okay.
We're going to do
Jodeci. I'm saying, y'all act like it's going to take hours or something. Yeah, like, what are you talking about?
Okay, we're going to do one.
Remember the Time, boo.
Hold on. Let me do something.
What you got to do?
Now you just going to play it. Everybody going to reflect. He going to play the record, and we all going to reflect about what we were doing at the time of the record. And
see, my memory don't work like that. Let me say this for you. That's your shit that work like that.
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
It was
mm-hmm.
Bob.
Never heard who
knew.
For real?
What?
Hey, man. That first Outkast album?
Really, now?
I never heard them. I swear I never heard.
I never heard that shit.
I'm just crumbling.
But I'm going to find them now so I can listen to them.
Wow.
Hey, that's when man, everybody realized Andre.
I didn't discover Outkast until, to be honest with you, I didn't discover Outkast until they had the song Me and You.
Yo mama, that's second album.
I didn't discover that. And I was in Chicago. I said, hey, man, listen to this. This is some of that country shit right here. This shit.
Yeah.
We ain't say Atlanta. We say they're from Georgia right here and shit. This Georgia music. That's what we were saying. Yeah. This Georgia music.
Really?
Yeah.
We'll take that.
What them other books say? You
what we're going to do right here is go back.
Way back.
Back into time.
All right, Dose.
All right. This first one is Forever My Lady. This song came out in 1991.
91. Really?
Oh, yeah. Dose came out in 91.
Damn.
And people think this is their first single, but that's their second single. They had a song out before this. But how I got introduced to this song was my partner, older brother, event brother, Bucci. Bucci was in college in Savannah State.
I remember that, Savannah, yeah.
And he came back up here. All he kept saying, man, y'all got a hitty bar. These bar right here, something else, but this shit here. And he was just playing it. So this Forever My Lady, and it's produced by Devontae Swing and Al B. Sure. People don't know that.
Oh, okay.
But and written by Devontae Swing, too, so, and Al B. Sure, so.
Okay.
And this song Al B. Sure wrote was about Kim Porter. So everybody know Kim Porter for
being
perfect. But she was actually Al B. Sure girl.
Okay. Yeah. When this song came out.
Hey, man, this song, let me tell you something. Jodeci, we used to be so, like, that's when we first started getting into music.
Yep.
Like, we used to be so fascinated how they got it to sound like that. Because we used to sit down, like, we would literally just listen to these songs over and over and just listen to them harmonies and stuff, how they did all that stuff.
Yeah.
That shit was just so amazing. We couldn't believe it. Like, they really was one of the first, like, groups, one of the first groups that really made us think about how to craft music. You know, how, like, wonder how they get it to sound like that. Like,
right.
Questioning shit about the music. But, like, that song there, shout out to Jodeci. That they started, I ain't gonna say they started something, but after them.
Yeah, Shy, that was all the, that was the level. Came.
Well, actually, Shy came along right along the same, like, right after that. I don't know if
they
came before then or after that.
Shy was.
It's sort of like.
Four, because then Jodeci had, like, I'm Still Waiting. Wasn't that their first song?
Well, nah, their first song was a dance song, didn't do nothing. But
okay.
This was their first one, like 91.
Okay.
Did Shy come before? I think Shy came
I
after Jodeci.
I think Shy was in 88.
Really?
Shy, hold on.
Yeah.
I don't think it was that. I don't think it was that early.
Let me see.
Because I can remember, like, me and Josh was old people. Like, we stayed at the house and watched videos. And I remember them. I thought that was the 90s.
Was it the 90s? I thought I could have sworn it was like 88, 89.
Shy. Hey, I don't know.
Like, they came 90, out,
see, I
like,
figured, it, I
like,
figured
they,
that.
They came out, like, it was, like, sort of the same time, like, because you remember, after the success of Boyz II Men and then Jodeci, all the grooves that everybody started putting out grooves then. So
from H-Town,
so it came out like I remember H-Town. H-Town was like 9 to 3.
Yeah,
like
I
92, 93, H-Town. Mm,
okay.
Yeah, bro. Like them cats down though. Like, man, we used to sit down listening to them. Right, and listen to them songs, like we knew them songs just weren't quite right. Like they weren't the best songs, but we used to love them songs.
They weren't quite right.
No, they weren't quite, but we used to love them songs.
Now that you look back on it.
We're doing this one for all the ladies. H-Town boys. Kicking it with my boy Luke. For the 9-3, you know what I'm saying? Because we will be knocking the boots. Shazam, Dino. They gonna do a little something for you, real sexy, like, you know what I'm saying?
I work in that greater hospital.
Check the verse.
A late night on the back when we made good love, listening to some Marvin Gaye all night long. I won't let a whole thing back to make these moments once again apparent. So won't you, do it for us, babe. Good loving body, rocking, knocking boots all night long. Making love till we're tired to the break of dawn. But come on, come on and turn the lights down. Cause when I do to me and you, it'll be so right.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all know that H-Town.
Oh, yes. Okay. H-Town.
Okay, okay.
So, they, you know, that was era in music. I don't know if we'll ever get back to that, per se, but we need to get back to more of a, everything can be about get high.
Drugs and slapping women.
Fucking women and like
we need some real love music. Like
that shit need to come back.
Yes, and like, I think that's why I like Juno Carter music. You know what I'm saying? Like him and Michael Jamar.
Mm-hmm.
Like they have that because like with Juno Carter, he's younger, so he has that still have that young spin on it.
Right.
But the lyrics and what he's actually
doing.
Talking about is reflecting love. Now Michael Jamal is a beast,
mm-hmm.
and he you know talking about that old school love.
Yeah, right.
We gotta get back to that. Like with the music, like the music says a lot. Like we, you know, I think what has happened is hip hop has took such of a mainstream approach,
mm-hmm.
and most of the hip hop folks, that's all they want to talk about is, you know, it's different love. So yeah. Thought Babies and shit. Y'all heard that Thought Babies?
No, I have not heard that.
You gotta play Throat Babies.
Yeah,
you gotta play Throat Babies.
Throat Babies.
Yes, Throat Babies. I was like, y'all for real.
Now I wasn't surprised about the song. I was surprised that the motherfucker was playing on the radio. I like that song. It's catchy.
It's
called Throat Babies. Who the hell don't want? Hey man, Throat Babies. I don't know, man. Nigga don't like Throat Babies. So this song here.
Throat Babies.
Throat Babies. That's the name of the song.
And you like it.
Well, play it.
I'm gonna play it a little bit.
I mean, it's catchy. I didn't know what they were saying at first. It took my brother to tell me what they were saying.
Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke. Throw babies, I'm trying to give it to you. Throw babies, I'm trying to bust all on you. Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke. Throw babies, I'm trying to give it to you. Throw babies, I'm trying to bust all on you. Got a little hunter,
just if you want it. That's your little 40. Gotta come right now. And I got beans you bite down. Super good head, no cap gown. Since the first time been peenie, couldn't even believe it. Hair like that shit, pussy don't need it. When she get home, she eat my seat. Miles an hour with her mouth, she clean it. Washing machine, trick, ooh. Shawty got me drip, ooh. Know what she came to do. Suck the dick, then she dip, ooh. Head monster, set her appointment. Mouth so wet, need your anointing. Way too good, may buy you something. Made a whole song, CIA fronting. I shoot the world for you. I go to war for you.
Yeah.
Damn, they got me tripping.
Yeah.
BOA head made me come instant.
She yeah, let it hook one more time. Gotta hit that hook one more time.
Cause I'm a kid. Here you go, here you go. Money I give to her. Cock on rocks I give to her.
Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat till I make you choke.
Throw baby. I'm trying to give them to you. Throw baby. I'm trying to bust all on you. Sexy little bitch, sexy little hoe. I love the way you walk, love the way you talk. Let a young nigga come play in your throat. Deep stroke your throat.
I cannot.
Hey. Them the love songs, y'all. Throat baby. Right. That what we got. That what we got. We got to deal with it.
Them the new love. Them the new Johnson
hey,
joints, right?
Hey, man. Throat babies. We stuck
throat
with
baby.
Them. Throat baby. I'm trying to get him up to
he
trying
to get some throat babies.
Say
what? Baby. Man, when I figured out he was saying throat baby, I was dead. I could have fell out of it. When I, cause I kept living, like, what the fuck is he saying? Then my bro was like, man, nigga saying throat babies. I said, throat baby. Man, I like to fell out. I said, come on. That's what it is, y'all. We need more love artists. We need more artists, singing artists. And the singing rapping is cool, but we need some crooners, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like it's cool to start by singing like dudes. Now, even the dudes that can sing don't want to sing. They want to rap. Like,
look at Damian at Dundon Lil Pop.
I know y'all would be surprised how many of these rappers can really, really sing. But they not finna get out there and all that shit. They want to look cool. They want to be fly. So they'll throw the raps in there. But a lot of them really can sing. Like, they sing, but they ain't going
to lie down with Throw Baby.
Throw Baby. That nigga
was all
like,
long
I'm
too.
Trying to give it to you. Throw Baby.
No,
no. I want to fuck all on you.
Thank y'all for tuning in.
Yep. Check out next week. We're going to flashback on more memories.
Remember
and we'll see y'all next
time.
Week. Same Misfit time, same Misfit station.
Yes.
This kid Jamal Reach. I'm tuning in right now. Westside Misfits. 3 p.m. 24/7, 365. DJ Loud. Let's get it. Get in the mix. I'm in the mix. 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 Westside Misfits. Get in the mix. Westside Misfits. Get in the mix. Get in the mix. I'm 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 in the mix. Westside Misfits. Get in the mix. Westside Misfits. Get in the mix. Going live 3 o'clock p.m. You need some service, hit them in they DM. When I'm at the spot, go and get the pot. Cooking work while I listen to me mix a lot. They don't tell lies, they just state facts. Hurry up, go and follow, it's Tay-Mac. Slick 316, be wildin'. Shout out Dose, not a 2000. Get in the mix, I'm in the mix. 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 Westside Misfits, get in the mix. Westside Misfits, get in the mix. Get in the mix, I'm 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 in the mix. Westside Misfits, get in the mix. Westside Misfits, get in the mix. Westside Misfits.